Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are back here at the beautiful site that is PSJA Stadium. Football is finally back here for Friday nights here in South Texas. Tonight's matchup, we have the Donna North Chiefs versus the PSJA Bears. This game is being brought to you by the hardworking crew of KTRI. My name is Isaac Sutton, the man to my right. The man who makes my job easy, the man himself, Javi Martinez. How you doing tonight, Javi?
It's a pleasure to be here, Isaac. You know, Friday night football, Friday night lights here in Texas, that's what it's all about. And here at home, we have the PSJA Mighty Bears coming out, taking the field. The crowd is roaring. It's going to be a festive night, opening night. They got the visiting Donna North Chiefs visiting tonight.
Last year was a little bit of a tough season for the Bears. They do have 14 returning starters, eight of which they're on offense. Some of those key players returning, running backs Mark Castillo, Josh Almaguer, wide receiver Anthony Dunaway, and quarterback Trey Guajardo, who got a lot of playing time coming in last year as a freshman. And now he looks to be the guy. Last year they had five different guys play the quarterback position.
Right, Isaac. And at the end, it was baptism by fire for Trey Guajardo. He came in the last two, three games. He did an awesome job, really sparked the team. They picked up their initial win, which came up against Donna North, their very first opponent this evening. So they're still young. Of course, Trey Guajardo barely a sophomore, but they got all five offensive starters on the offensive line coming back. They got some key players in skill positions. Their defense is still questionable, but I see the Bears being much, much upgraded this year. A very talented football team.
And it'll be the Bears kicking off to the Chiefs to start our first Friday night game here at PSJA Stadium.
Big it up for the Bears to start the contest, number 28.
And that'll be number 28 handling the kicking duties for the Bears. That's, sophomore Ruben Vera. Back returning for the Chiefs, we have number 14, Alex Gonzalez, and number 26, Elias Garcia. And here's the kick. It's a high short kick fielded at the 30, picked up by number 83, Juan Reyna. Well, I shouldn't say picked up, actually fell on it right there on the 30. And that's where the Chiefs offense, led by senior quarterback Alex Sines. And they look to get their first offensive drive going here against the Bear defense.
And the strong suit last year for Donna North was their defense. They played outstanding defensive football the entire year. They really struggled offensively, but let's see what kind of upgrades they made. Let's see if the transition from their sophomore juniors to their senior year makes an impact on this season. And of course, the Bears last year, they played well defensively. They gave up a little bit too many points. They've got some substantial kids coming back, I think four starters on defense, so it should be a very, very interesting football game tonight.
Alex Sines takes the snap, hands this one off to the running back. That's number 28 getting the first carry of the game. That's Dominic Ochoa. He's brought down by number 6, Rigo Horta, the senior defensive back. Tackles for a loss, so that'll make it 2nd and 13 with the ball placed at the 28-yard line.
Yeah, great effort right there by the senior, Mr. Rigo Horta, cutting down the ball carry before he slipped off on the left side of the offensive line. Loss of 2 yards. Good start for the Bears right now.
Sines takes a snap. He's going to hand this one off once again to the running back. That is Ochoa breaking free. Crosses midfield. He's at the 30. Getting to the 25, the 20. Now he's at the 10. He's finally brought down, but it looks to be a little too late. They're going to say he made it into the end zone.
Yes, he did. That's a huge 72-yard touchdown run on 2nd down. You know, very auspicious start for Donna North. If you're a Donna North fan, you know, they lose 2 yards on the first play. Tackle behind the line of scrimmage. It's the same ball carrier. Dominic Ochoa gets a good seal block around the right edge. And then he's off to the races. No doubt about that one. Great effort on the Bears to try to track him down, but it was a little bit too late. And Donna North with a quick 6-0 lead.
And as you said, Javi, it only took the Chiefs 2 plays to go 75 yards. really 7 yards. They started at their own 30.
Yeah, they had a loss of a couple yards, so.
And so the Chiefs strike first. Our score here at PSJA Stadium, it's the Bears 0, Chiefs 7. We still have 11 minutes and 7 seconds left in this opening quarter.
And that is not the way Coach Marroquin wanted this football season to get started. Of course, on first down, a great defensive effort by Rigo Orta. But then on second down, a bit of a breakdown. The ball carrier gets quickly into the second, third level without being touched. And then after that, it's a foot race. And, of course, he won that foot race. Extra point is good. So the Chiefs are up 7-0. But, of course, there's 11:07 remaining in the first quarter. A lot of ball game to be played. And I thought this was going to be a defensive game. This might be one of those high-scoring affairs where the first team to reach 40 is going to win tonight.
And now the Chiefs will be getting ready to kick this one off. Handling the kicking duties for the Chiefs, I believe that's number 30, Christian Bustos. I'm sorry, that's number 20. Rigoberto Escobar. Back returning for the Bears, we have number 4, Marco Guajardo.
No, that's Gus Calvillo. Gus Calvillo.
And this one's fielded by number 20. And they'll take it down to about the 30-yard line. That was Almaguer with the return. Making the tackle there was number 83, Juan Reyna. And so now we'll see sophomore Trey Guajardo.
And he's going to be flanked by some good running backs with Castillo and Almaguer. I think this is the key to the Bears' season right here, their offense. It's one of those type of years they're going to have to outscore their opponents. And I think they got the right man behind center, Trey Guajardo.
Guajardo takes a snap. He's dropping back, looking left, pump fakes. Now goes to his right, has Anthony Dunaway wide open. He makes the catch, still on his feet, and finally brought down at about the 21-yard line. Making the tackle there was number 14, Alex Gonzalez. Gain of 42 yards. And now the Bears trying to rush back to the line of scrimmage. They'll line up in a five receiver set. With Castillo there at the outside. Guajardo takes the handoff. He's going to keep this one himself. Gets inside the 15-yard line. That was number 14, Alex Gonzalez, in on the tackle.
Yeah, that's a good surge by the offensive line right there, giving the running back plenty of room to maneuver himself for 7 strong yards. Second and short for the Bears on the attack already.
And here's Castillo getting his first carry of the game. He gets it inside the 10, down to about the 7-yard line. And that's going to be well enough for a first down.
And a good job right there by the left side of the Bears offensive line, giving Castillo enough room to maneuver for the first down. Gets all the way down to the 7, as you mentioned, Isaac. And the Bears, even though they gave up a quick touchdown in 2 plays, this is their 3rd offensive play, and they're knocking on the door. First and goal for the Bears.
Empty backfield set for Guajardo with his man in motion. That's Gus Calvillo. He'll take the handoff. He gets inside the 5. Forced out of bounds by number 6, Nick Benya. And it looks like they're going to mark him out of bounds at about the 4-yard line, or the 3-yard line. So it'll be second and goal from the 3. PSJA knocking on that door of the end zone with 9 minutes and 40 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. Guajardo takes a snap. This one's going to be a handoff to Almaguer. Almaguer gets around the edge and into the end zone. A 3-yard touchdown run by Almaguer, and the Bears are on the scoreboard, trailing by 1, pending the extra point. A nice drive there by the PSJA Bears.
Yes, it was. You know, it all started with Guajardo with a long pass to Dunaway. a couple of power runs up the middle, and then a couple of jet sweeps to finish off the drive. Great comeback after falling quickly 7-0. The Bears fight back. They're a point away, an extra point away, excuse me, from tying up the ballgame.
And here's the kick through the upright. So now we have a tie game here at PSJA Stadium. It's the Bears 7, Chiefs 7, with 9 minutes and 35 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. And you might have been right, Hoppy. What we thought was going to be a defensive showdown.
Mm-hmm.
Both offenses coming in quick, as we see here on the replay. Maguette just able to get around the edge there. Basically goes into the end zone untouched. He ties up this ball game.
Yes, I was anticipating one of those showdowns where it, roll up your sleeves and the best defensive team is going to win, but I was clearly wrong.
And it looks like the running back, Mark Castillo, after one of his carries, he kind of limped off the field. Now he's kind of walking up and down the sidelines there, trying to get warmed up. Hopefully it's nothing too serious and he'll be back out on the field, as he looks to be a big part of this offense.
Yes, he will be. And so far, we haven't even put ourselves 3 minutes in the ballgame, 2.5 minutes. We already have 14 points. Electrifying start to this Friday night here at PSJA Stadium.
And here's the kick, bounces at the 10, then rolls out of bounds. So we'll get our first penalty for tonight's game. Jerry Sanchez was the closest chief, and he wisely let that one roll out of bounds. And now we'll get the call from the head official.
Legal procedure on the kicking team. The Chiefs will take the football at the own 30-yard line.
You heard it there, folks. The Chiefs will have it first and 10 at their own 30-yard line after the illegal procedure with the kick going out of bounds. So here comes back Alex Sainz for his second drive. After their last one only took two plays for them to get into the end zone. High snap, Sainz takes this one, hands this one. Well, that's a fake handoff, keeps this one to himself. Gets around the right edge, has a first down and more. Finally forced out of bounds by number 22, Frank Cantu. So it'll be first and 10 for the Chiefs as they have it at the PSJA 46-yard line.
Yeah, just like that on one play, a quarterback keeper picks up 24 yards on that first play. So right now that offense is clicking for Donna North. The Bears need to come up with some answers quickly, as Donna North is setting camp already, first and 10 at the Bear 46-yard line.
Play clock down to 5 seconds. Sainz takes the snap, fakes the handoff to one running back, hands it off to another. This is number 21, Tony Gomez, getting the carry.
Number 21, Tony Gomez.
Forced out of bounds by number 7, Gabriel Espinosa, and number 22, Frank Cantu. But we do have another flag thrown.
Holding number 87 for the offense. That's a 10-yard penalty. Repeat the down. First down.
That penalty is going to go against the tight end, Angel Lopez. And so it'll push him back 10 yards.
Yeah, that may be the reason, Isaac, that the Donna North is being so successful. Maybe they got a hole in there and they weren't called in the earlier plays and picked up huge chunks of yards. That time they were called, driven back 10 yards. It's first and 19 for Donna North.
Sainz takes the snap, hands this one off to the running back, puts a spin move, gets back to the original line of scrimmage. As Tony Gomez getting the carry, takes it down to the PSJA 45-yard line. That was number 19 making the tackle, Marco Pedraza.
Right now it's evident, Isaac, they're exploiting that right side or the left side of the Bear defensive front. That offensive line is doing a great job at the point of attack, making easy opening holes for those running backs to run through.
Second and 10. Ball still at the 46-yard line. Sines takes the snap, fakes the handoff, rolls out to his left, fires it out to the running back in the flat, but it bounces off his chest and falls incomplete.
And I think the proper terminology was fires it out there. He had no chance of catching. Wide open man coming out of the backfield into the flat. Could have picked up a good 10, 15 yards. It was wide open, but that ball was just a little bit too much mustard on that one, a little bit too much adrenaline flowing through Science's blood right there. Incomplete pass. Big break for the Bears, and that forces the Donna North Redskins into a very long third and 10 at the Bears' 46-yard line.
Third and 10 now for Sines and the Chiefs. He takes the snap. He's rolling out to his left. Finds the intended receiver. This one's tipped by one receiver and falls into the hands of another. That was intended for number 26, Elias Garcia, but ended up in the hands of Corey Harrison.
You know they practice that all the time, the good old
tip drill.
Tip drill right there, and you gotta have Lady Luck on your side, and that's exactly what the Chiefs had. Picks up another big first down, keeps the chains moving, and they are now at the bare 30-yard line. Of course, we're all 7-7 right now, midway through the first quarter here at PSJA Stadium.
First and 10 ball at the 30-yard line. Sines takes the snap, but looks like we had a timeout first.
Before the delay of the game, we had a timeout. Timeout, Chiefs.
So the Chiefs wisely using their first timeout of the half before they let the game clock, I'm sorry, the play clock run out on them.
Yeah, they were a little bit late coming out of the huddle. And right now they got a lot of momentum on that offense. You'd hate to stall that or, you know, one of those penalty ending drives, although it's just first down. But when you're at the 30-yard line, you're already in striking distance. And right now it's a 7-7 ball game, which appears to be perhaps a very high scoring ball game, as we already have 14 points. We're not even 6 minutes into the first quarter. So a good timeout right there by Donna North.
7 minutes and 39 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. We still have a tied ball game, 7-7. Now the offense getting set. Sines under center, takes the snap. He'll pitch this one out to 28, Dominic Ochoa. And he's brought down by number 55, Jacob Sanchez, but we do have another flag thrown.
Yeah, Dominic Ochoa had a huge hole to run through. Let's see if that was another holding penalty.
Personal foul, cutting on the line. That's a 15-yard penalty. Number 72 for the offense.
So a personal foul against the offense will push him back 15 yards. They were making some progress. Now they have to go all the way back to the... Looks like they're going to be pushing back to the 45. Well, it'll be 15 yards from the spot of the penalty. Oh my God, that's right, 45-yard line.
Yep.
That was the longest walk I've ever seen him have to do.
He took a Sunday stroll on that one, that's for sure. In either case, it's a big break for the Bears right there. Big help taking that penalty. It's going to be first and 25. Instead of the Chiefs being at the bare 30, they're pushed back all the way to the 45.
Now the referee is just making sure everything seems to be squared away between the referee and the...
Yeah, and I think they're talking about whether it was a spot foul, and if it was, it occurred at about the 28, which would give, you know, the Chiefs maybe the ball at the 43.
And it looks like that's exactly what they're doing, because they're going to move it to about the 42.
42, okay, so it happened, you know, at the 27, I believe, then. And it's the first game for everybody, not just the Chiefs and the Bears, but for the whole officiating crew.
And Sines takes the snap. This is Ochoa getting the handoff once again. That was number six, Rigoota making the tackle there. Also along with number 16, A.J. Gomez.
Yeah, good stop right there. That's one of the better plays of the Bears defense have had. Although there was a few yards picked up on the play, the Bears finally are sniffing out that run, and they're going to need to because that's all we've seen so far from these Donna North Chiefs tonight.
Here's another pitch. This one is to Ochoa. And he's finally brought down by number 70, Roman Garza. And Ochoa is able to take that down to about the 31-yard line.
And A.J. Gomez was in the backfield on that one. One of those corner blitzes, and he was back there. Made a hit, initial hit, about 2-3 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to wrap up. Still, the Bears are forcing the Chiefs into a third and long situation.
Third and 11 with 6 minutes left. Here's Sines rolling out to his right. Fires this one to the receiver. That's caught by number 30, Christian Bustos. But he's well short of the first down. He rolls out of bounds right about the 26.
So it's early in the ball game, Isaac. You know, it's 7-7 tie. It's a little bit under 550 remaining in the ball game. Let's see what Donna North decides to do. They are at the Bears' 26-yard line. Of course, that offense has been executing extremely well. And it may be a little bit out of field goal range for them.
Sines takes snap, rolls out to his right, has the receiver. And this one was almost caught. Well, they're going to
wow,
say he caught
said,
it, but
I thought he juggled
like
it. Yes, I thought he juggled it before he, well, you know, there's no instant replay out here, but from our vantage point, it looked like an incomplete pass, like he bobbled it, juggled it, it fell to the floor, but nonetheless, they're saying it's a catch. Okay, here
now
we go.
Now they're going to rule it incomplete.
Right,
there we go.
Okay, there we go. Overruled. Thank you very much, Mr. Head Official right there.
I think he saw the same thing that we did.
Yes, yes.
And so the Bears, the defense stopping them on fourth down. Here we'll see on the replay. Well, you know what? There's no challenges, but here we do get instant replay. And there you see right there as he's heading out of bounds, he just lets that one fall out of his hands.
Mm-hmm. It was right in front of the official, but... And I think that's what the coach from North is arguing. Like, the man who's 2 feet away clearly said it was a catch, but then he was overruled, which I think the right call was made. And that's the best thing for these kids because they're hustling, trying to do their best, and the call, right call was made right there.
Here's Guajardo faking the handoff to Almaguer. And Guajardo takes it all the way down to about the 37 as he's brought down by number six, Nick Pena. And well, I'm sorry, number 60, Miguel Perales. So it'll be first and 10 for the Bears.
Yeah, good runner up right up the middle right there by Guajardo. Picking out a hole, picking up 11 yards, moving the chains. 7-7 tie right here, the Bears.
And here's Anthony Dunaway taking the snap, and he'll hand this one off to Almaguer. And Almaguer takes it inside the 40-yard line.
Yeah, very interesting. You know, they pulled Guajardo out. I don't know if it was an equipment issue or maybe. Okay, there we go. The helmet came off. So by rule, that player must
sit out one play.
So there we go. The eye in the sky calling the right things.
And here is number four, Gus Calvillo, getting the handoff on the end around. Gets a first down, but as he crosses the first down marker, a flag gets thrown.
Yeah, very good run right there by the Bears, crossing midfield, almost getting to the Chiefs 40-yard line, but let's see what the penalty is. Usually in this area, it's a holding, and it does appear to be coming back.
Holding, number 20 for the offense, 10-yard penalty. Second down.
So after the holding penalty, they'll be pushed back to about the 35-yard line.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be second and 13. Empty backfield for Guajardo. And now Calvillo, the man in motion. And this is going to be a keeper by Guajardo. And it looks like he might have fumbled that ball.
He fumbled it. Picked up. I want to say he was down by contact. It should be Donna North's ball, though. Guajardo trying to get that extra effort, picking up one or two more yards. Fumbles it. After about an 8-9 yard pickup, Donna North tries to run it back, but I think when they recovered the ball, his knee was touching down by.
Well, they're going to say that it was that they're going to say that Guajardo was actually down
by
contact.
Okay, well, great. There we go. The Bears catch a break. That was
Very close.
Yes, and the interesting thing was they let him play. I didn't hear a whole bunch of whistles out there. That's why I assumed it was a fumble, but good break for the Bears, and now they possibly get somebody jump off sides. It was a 3rd and 4. That should be an automatic first down for the Bears.
Defense, offsides, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That was number 60, Miguel Perales, the guilty party, and that's going to give the Bears an automatic first down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what a turn of events. The Chiefs thought they had recovered a fumble. The Bears force them into a offsides penalty, and they're about close to midfield at the Bears 48-yard line.
Play clock down to 10 seconds as we see Guajardo checking his wristband. And Guajardo takes the snap, fakes the handoff to Almaguer, avoids pressure, now rolls out to his left. Tries to fire this one, throws it down the middle of the field, a dangerous throw.
Yeah, that you don't want to do that. It was completed, but I tell you what, in retrospect, you don't want to do that. Just put it in your back pocket or run out of bounds. But nonetheless, you know, the kid's a stud. He knows what he's doing. Makes a pass completion, picks up 7 yards out of nothing.
That was Nathan Miranda making the catch, being brought down by number 40, Gus Escalante. And a nice pickup on a broken first down play. Mm-hmm. Picks up 7 yards, but as we said, it was a dangerous throw.
Yeah, throwing across his back down the center, and he just floated that one. So luckily for the Bears, they pick up 7 yards, retain possession.
And Galvio takes the handoff on a jet sweep, gets around the edge, picks up the first down, but another flag is thrown. And finally steps out of bounds near the Donna Chief 33-yard line.
Yeah, but I think it was a hole that sprung him around the left edge right in front of the Donna North bench.
Holding, number 20 for the offense, 10-yard penalty, second down.
And that's a second holding penalty against the Bears on this possession. And those are tough to overcome. Those are 10-yard penalties. You know, instead of the Bears being almost at the Chiefs' 30-yard line, that pushes them back onto their side of the football field at their own 48.
And this looks to be another free play. Well, Guajardo's going to throw this one. The intended receiver was number, I believe that was number 88, Marco Herrera. But I think it was a free play. We had a defender jump offsides.
Offsides, number 60 for the defense. That's a 5-yard penalty. Second down.
That's his second infraction right there for offsides. But in all honesty, Isaac, you know, if Guajardo with a little bit more maturity, of course, he's just a sophomore. He's only got 3 or 4 varsity games under his belt. That's one you got to throw over everybody's head. You know, only one man can catch it, and that's a receiver. And if he does, he may be dancing in the end zone right now.
So the penalty makes it 2nd and 6. Empty backfield set for Guajardo. Now looking to the sidelines as he's getting a play call for Maruquin. 15 seconds left on the play clock. Guajardo takes a snap. He's looking right. Now he's going to scramble. Crosses the 40-yard line. Fumbles this one, but it goes out of bounds. Number 10, Ruben Garza with the force out. But it's going to be a first down for the Bears.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, good tough running right there by Guajardo. Lowers his head. Tries to take on the tackler. Luckily for him, though, he did fumble, but it does go out of bounds. The Bears retain possession, and they're going to spot that ball just inside the Chiefs' 37-yard line. So we got 2:44 remaining in the first quarter. The Bears and the Chiefs in a deadlock, 7-7.
Almaguer, the man in motion. He'll take this handoff, breaks the tackle in the backfield, and looks to have enough yards for the first. Mm-hmm. It was number 14, Alex Gonzalez.
Yeah, that's just another sweep right there, a jet sweep using Almaguer's strength. That's his speed, and I really like seeing that.
Timeout, Chief.
Almaguer can fly. He can get around the edges, and that's what the Bears need.
So the Chiefs take their second timeout.
And a good position right now for the Bears. This position, of course, started at their own 26-yard line. Three first downs later, and they are getting into scoring position. You know, they're at the Chiefs' 28-yard line. They got to get to about the inside the 26, 27 for the first down.
And we still haven't seen Mark Castillo back in the game since the opening drive.
Exactly. That's a great point right there. They've been going with other guys. Of course, Castillo coming into his senior year, a three-year letterman, three-year starter for that. You know, he's their workhorse. He's their muscle guy. He's their bruiser, you know, right up the middle. Tonight, you know, they can't utilize that as of yet. He started the ball game, got injured early on. We haven't seen him yet. He's been pacing around, though. He's been, you know, maybe he's probably itching to get back in there. We just don't know exactly what's wrong with him.
So with 2 minutes and 21 seconds left to go in this first quarter, Ojardo takes the snap. He's looking right, fires this one in the direction of Anthony Dunaway. And this one nearly caught. Not sure if he would have landed in bounds.
Yeah, good throw by Ojardo right there, leading Dunaway to the corner of the end zone. Just past the front pylon, but as you mentioned, Isaac, I don't think he would have came up with it. You know, Dunaway is about 6'2", 6'3", great athlete, multi-sport athlete. He just couldn't come down with it. Incomplete pass brings up a third and short for the Bears.
Third and one, ball on the 28-yard line. Play clock down to 5 seconds. Empty backfield for Ojardo. Almaguer, the man in motion. And Ojardo fakes the jet sweep, takes this one up the middle, has enough for the first down. Alex Gonzalez, number 14, there making the tackle for the Chiefs. And it's another Bear first down as they have it first and 10 at the 22-yard line.
Yeah, good job of blocking right there. Sealing off the guard and tackle trap right there for the Bears. Picking up the first down, giving Ojardo enough room to get a first down.
Ojardo takes the snap. He's looking right. Fires this one. It's short, and it falls into the hands of the defender.
We do have a late flag in the backfield, though. Well, Ojardo under duress just kind of heaved that one up. He threw it into double coverage, and the end result was an interception for a touchback.
That was intercepted by number 14, Alex Gonzalez.
And it appears that Donna North is declining an illegal man downfield, which will give the Chiefs.
Illegal man downfield for the offense. Penalty declined. First and 10, Chiefs.
You know, I'm really not sure that Gonzalez actually didn't catch that at the one.
Yeah, right. Well, it's one of those, Isaac, where I guess it's a judgment call, and you may say, well, his momentum brought him into the end zone, but, you know, being biased, being the home team tonight, I'd say spot him right at the half-inch line. You know, make him go 99 and three-quarter yards. Instead, they're going to start at the 20.
Sainz takes the high snap, hands this one off to Ochoa, and he fumbles this one, picked up by the Bears. That looks like A.J. Gomez with the recovery. That was number 19 for the Bears. The sophomore Marco Pedraza causing Ochoa to fumble.
Yeah, that was one of those classic you know, Choa gets to the line of scrimmage, hits the second level, gets hit, tries to pick up an extra 2 or 3 yards. Nothing but hustle, but unfortunately for the Chiefs, he does fumble, and a big break right there for the Bears as they just threw an interception in the end zone. They get it right back. They're going to start at the Chiefs' 31-yard line.
Play clock down to 15 seconds. Get the man in motion. He'll take it on a jet sweep. Gets around the edge. Gets to the inside the 20. He's at the 10. He's going to score. Unfortunately, we do have a flag thrown at the 28-yard line. And when it's thrown there, that looks like it's going to be a holding penalty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's coming back all right.
Holding number 76 for the offense. 10-yard penalty. First down.
That penalty going against Nathaniel Herrera, the senior offensive lineman. So erase the 31-touchdown run by Almaguer, and it's now first and 17 with the ball placed at the 38-yard line. Four receivers set for Guajardo.
And again, the Chiefs are drawn off sides.
Contact by the defense, number 60. That's a 5-yard penalty. First down.
Well, they said 5-yard penalty. I don't know if it's an, I don't think it's an automatic first down.
Well, it was first down to begin with. So
I replay think, first down.
Yes, there we go. It's not first and 10, by no means. It'll be about first and about 11 or 12. You know, down the north, jumping the gun. They got four defensive linemen. They got two linebackers playing a 4-2-5, if you will, 4-2-4. And, you know, they're just jumping the gun. They're anxious to get after the quarterback.
I do believe this is their third encroachment penalty
yes,
on this
is.
Drive.
Yes, it is.
So here's Guajardo dropping back, looks to his right, fires in the direction of Anthony Dunaway, who makes the reception. He's inside the 25-yard line, down at about the 22. Oscar Salas making the tackle there for the Chiefs. That'll make it second and one. And here's Guajardo, who's going to run this one himself.
Ooh,
takes a hard hit.
Wow, he got belted. He got hit hard. That's one of those, once again, you know, you got to love the fact he's a great athlete. He's only a sophomore, a bit inexperienced still. That's one of those, you know, you just duck, get out of bounds. Save that body, save that energy for later on. But he took a beating right there. Luckily, he did hold on to the ball. Big time first down for the Bears. Shows a lot of guts. Right there by Guajardo.
He's there standing next to Marroquin. Marroquin's probably telling him the same thing. Hey, just get out of bounds.
We got 9 more games to go, son. We're not even in the district yet.
Here's the handoff to Almaguer, who gets it down to about the 15. Tackle made by number 33, Jerry Chavez. Speaking of big hits, we want to wish Michael Contreras out of PSJA North a speedy recovery. A tragic injury for the first game of the JV season. So a shout out to Michael Contreras. We wish you a speedy recovery, young man. That was Gus Calvillo with the catch as he takes it down to about the 5-yard line. It'll be first and goal for the Bears, actually from the 3-yard line.
Mm-hmm.
And we still have 10 seconds. It's still the first quarter.
Yeah, it is.
It's been a long first quarter.
It sure has, but it's been an entertaining first quarter.
Gus Calvillo, the man in motion. He'll take a fake handoff, and it's going to be Trey Guajardo fighting his way into the end zone for a 3-yard touchdown. And that'll put up the Bears 13-7, pending the extra points. with 3.8 seconds left to go here in the first quarter.
That's a very impressive drive by the Bears. Although you may see, well, it was only 31 yards. But to throw an interception in the end zone, come back, their defense gets an outstanding stop by forcing their own turnover. Bears take over in a short field. Take advantage of it. And just like that, the Bears are up now, 14-7.
The extra point is good. 3.8 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. Our score at PSJA Stadium, it's the Bears 14, the Chiefs 7.
And so far, so good for young Trey Wahatlo, you know, the sophomore who came in last year as a relief quarterback, if you will, last three games of the season, picked up one victory.
There we see on the replay, Wahatlo with the fake handoff, and he's just going to take this one himself up the middle.
Yeah, he's a true leader. You know, he's a humble guy, but he's a leader. He's a leader of this Bear football team. He's thrown over 60 yards tonight, rambled in for 3-yard touchdown, and because of that, you know, it's rare to say that, you know, a sophomore is leading your team, but so far so good for the Bears, 14-7 over a very tough Donna North football team that came ready to play tonight.
Ruben Vetta getting ready to kick for the Bears. Back to return for the Chiefs, number 26, Elias Garcia. Here's the kick from Vetta. Fielded by number 7, Jerry Sanchez. He's going to take it down to the right side of the field. Crosses the 20-yard line. And finally brought down at about the 25 by number 35, Raul Segura. And that'll end the first quarter here at PSJA Stadium. It was a lengthy first quarter. But as you said, Javi, it was very entertaining to say none the least. It's the Bears 14, the Chiefs 7, as we get ready to get this second quarter underway. It'll be first and 10 for the Chiefs as they begin at their own 25-yard line.
That's the end of the first quarter.
Now it's officially the end of the first quarter. I got a little
bit of myself.
There
we go. You got.
Yeah. I'm just anxious.
Nothing wrong with that. You're excited. I'm excited. Everybody's excited here. We got a good crowd on both sides of the stadium. Donna North, of course, a visiting team. Our pride of PSJA, the Bears, hosting opening night here on Friday night. They're doing a good job right now, up 14-7. And as you mentioned, Isaac, it's been a well-played football game. You know, it's been a couple of too many flags on the field. But other than that, it's been well played. I think we got two good football teams, two old foes from 32-5A going up against each other.
Here's the handoff to Ochoa, breaking some tackles. Finally brought down by number 12, Jose Garza. And Garza trying to actually strip Ochoa as they were able to do so on that last offensive drive that the Chiefs had. So we'll keep looking for that to see if that's a strategy they keep trying to do, just strip it out and get the ball back into the hands of that PSJA offense. First and 10, ball at the 41. Sines takes the snap. He'll fake the handoff to Ochoa and keep this one himself, crosses midfield and has enough yards for the first down. That was number 35 making the tackle, Raul Segura. And it's another first down for the Chiefs.
And Ochoa's been a workhorse for the Chiefs. Of course, the Chiefs in the first quarter had three first downs. They scored one touchdown, totaling 127 yards on the other side of the ball. The Bears had 125 yards of total offense, so pretty even matchup so far.
And here's Sines with the carry. Brought down at the 45 by number 16, A.J. Gomez, and number 7, Gabriel Espinosa.
First and foul, chop block.
And that's the second chop block penalty against the Chiefs. That's been a killer. That's the one thing that has slowed the Chiefs down a little bit tonight. They've been doing a good job of executing, especially with Ochoa running the football. But those penalties, those are drive killers. You know, those are rally killers right there. And the Bears are more than happy to accept them, pushing the Chiefs all the way back to their own 38-yard line. Brings up a first and a marathon for the Chiefs.
First and about 26.
That is a marathon, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Here's Sines rolling out to his left. And he's going to bring that ball down, run this one himself.
Wow.
Big time hit right there by number 7 of the Bears.
That was number 7, Gabriel Espinosa, and number 34, Ezekiel Marroquin.
Yeah, that's one of the collisions when both players just fall back on their backside. That was a collision. Nobody won that battle. That was a standstill, but my goodness. Big time, bringing the lumber right there.
Second and 18 for the Chiefs. They have it at their own 46-yard line. As we've already gone 2 minutes into the second quarter, Sines takes a snap, hands this one off to Ochoa. And Ochoa breaking more tackles as he's done for most of the game. He's brought down by number 6, Rigo Horta. And actually, that was number 22, Mark Gutierrez, getting the carry. Nice run there by him.
Right. The only difference between Gutierrez and Ochoa is that, you know, Ochoa is a little bit more of a bruiser. The one thing you got to notice, though, Isaac, they keep exploiting that left side of the Bears defense.
Third and 9 now for the Chiefs. They have it at the PSJA 45. And Sines fakes the handoff, keeps this one himself. He's brought down by number 16, A.J. Gomez, and number 7, Gabriel Espinosa, but not before being able to pick up another first down.
Yeah, once again, right around their offensive side of the right side, this time just inside the tackle. Good effort there by the quarterback, and the Chiefs are quickly moving the ball. They're at the Bears' 34-yard line.
First and 10, ball at the 34.
Yeah, the Bears are countering with a three-man defensive front, three down linemen.
Sines rolling out to his left, fires this one into the direction of the intended receiver. That's number 36, Albert Tejada. And that'll make it second and 10.
Yeah, and Sines had to throw that one away, if you will, just a bit outside. It was good coverage by number 7 for the Bears. Gabriel Espinosa was right over the receiver, forcing the quarterback not to be able to complete that pass. Good effort right there by the secondary of the Bears.
Second and 10, ball still at the 34.
This time the Bears are going to counter with a four-man front.
And this is number 22 getting the carry, all the way down to the 24. He's brought down by number 19 of that PSJA defense. That's Marco Pedraza.
Yeah, that was one of those where you gamble. The defensive coordinator for the Bears, they had a run blitz right up the left side of the defense of the offensive front, right between the guard tackle, and set the Chiefs, guess right, and they went the opposite side on the right side of the line, and that's why they picked up first down.
Sines takes a snap, pitches this one out to Gutierrez. Gutierrez gets around the edge, and he looks to have enough yards for another first down. He's finally brought down by number 73, Eddie Gonzalez.
Got a little bit of extracurricular activity going on over there. We see the Donna North coach jumping around everywhere, the Bears sideline inching up to the numbers. And I'm not sure what happened. I didn't see what happened. It was clearly away from the football. In either case, it's another first down for the Chiefs, and they are now at the Bears' 14-yard line.
7.5 minutes left to go in the first half. It's the Bears 14, Chiefs 7, but the Chiefs,
they're driving. They're looking good. I think both offenses have looked very, very solid. The defense has been a bit suspect on both teams. But right now the Bears have the upper hand as they're clinging to a 14-7 lead.
Sines has this one off to Gutierrez, who takes it up the middle. Gets to about the 10. Marco Pedraza, number 19, making the tackle there for the Bears. And it's another first down for the Chiefs.
Oh, that'll be second down.
Second down. Yeah. There we see on the replay, just a handoff inside, but Pedraza able to get him down quick before he picks up a bigger gain. And it'll make it second and 6 from the 10. Here's the handoff to the running back, who's met in the backfield and brought down for a loss.
Excellent effort right there by the Bears.
That was number 34 making his way into the backfield, Ezekiel Marroquin. And so that'll make it a third down.
Yeah, Marroquin submarines himself into the backfield, disrupts a whole play. Big loss of yards right there on second down. Brings up a big third down right here for the Bears defense. They're forcing the Chiefs into a 3rd and 9 from the Bears 18-yard line.
Sines rolling out to his right, looking for a receiver, and finally forced out of bounds right around the 6-yard line.
Good pickup by Science. It's going to make a very interesting call right here. 4th down.
They needed to get to the 4, so that it's going to be 4th and 2.
Right.
Do they put points on the board, or do they try to get another first down?
That's the money question right now. They're going to think about it. They're going to call a timeout.
Got timeout. Timeout. Chiefs.
And so the Chiefs use their second timeout of the half. They have one more remaining with 5 minutes and 50 seconds left to go here in the second quarter, going a lot faster than that first quarter.
Mm-hmm. Right. Interesting situation coming up right here. And, you know, I'm a gambling man by nature. And I'd go for it. If you don't get it, you know, make the Bears go 95 yards or so. And if you do make it, it's going to be a good chance you score a touchdown and tie the ball game. So the Bears defense, I think they got to get amped up right here and get a big defensive stop. They want to continue holding on to this 14-7 lead. I think you call one of those run blitzes again. You know, guess right or left. Hopefully he gets the right side, the proper side anyway. Make a big time stop. Take over on downs.
So here we are, 4th and 2. Ball at the 6-yard line. Chiefs need to get to the 4 for it to be a first down. Sines takes the snap, hands this one off to Ochoa, and Ochoa's brought down right at around the 5. It's close.
I don't think they got it.
I agree with you. I don't think he got it.
I think he had to get inside the 5 into almost a 4-yard line. And the Bears are coming out clapping, happy, ecstatic that they made a tremendous stop right there on 4th and 2.
So another 4th down stop for this PSJA defense. And now there we see on the replay, just tries to go right up the middle, but it's number 70. Roman Garza just making a great defensive effort to keep Ochoa from getting that extra 1/2 yard that would have gotten him a first down.
Exactly. And right, once again, that was a run blitz to the left side of that offensive line. This time the Bears guessed correctly. They're able to stop the ball carrier just in time. And the Bears with a big time stop. And that's one of those, you know, can carry a lot of weight in the season. You know, you stop a team from scoring inside your own 5-yard line. You're up 14-7. Let's see what the Bears can do now.
So on first down, here's Almaguer getting the carry. Tries to get around the edge and does, but we have a flag thrown.
Almaguer with a carry down to the 18-yard line.
Flag number 14, providing the hit on Almaguer. That's Alex Gonzalez.
Holding number 72 for the offense. Half a distance to the goal line. First down. He says, Skeppy.
Well, not too sure much info there, but
that was there. Nonetheless, it's a 2.5-yard penalty against the Bears, and that negates a big run by Almaguer crossing the 20-yard line, but instead of 1st and 10, It'll be second and, well, actually first down again. First and 13. They'll call it first and 13.
Bears have it at their own two. Not a very safe place to have it. Guajardo standing in his own end zone with the play clock down to about 5 seconds. Takes a snap. He's looking right. Fires this one into the direction of Herrera. That was Marco Herrera, but he's unable to get to that one.
And I like the play call. You know, your back's against the end zone, but tell you what, the height advantage was huge right there between the receiver and the defender. And
they tried to capitalize on it, but they were unsuccessful.
And Guajardo just missed that. You know, he would have let him maybe one more yard. That would have been a great completion.
And then, well, I mean, you look over here on the left side, mm-hmm. you've got Oscar Salas who is guarding Anthony Dunaway. And as you said, Dunaway's about 6'3".
Yes.
But here's Guajardo taking this one himself, picks up a first down as he gets to the 30-yard line. Number 14 finally forcing him out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a big 27-yard run right there by Guajardo.
And they're going to mark him down at the 29-yard line.
And that's huge right there, Isaac. You know, getting out of the shadows of your own end zone, picking up the first down, you got some breathing room.
And here's Guajardo. Now he's going to roll to his left.
That could have very well been a penalty at the end of the game. Guajardo rolls around and a defender kind of spearheads him, you know, utilizing his helmet. No penalty was called. Kind of shook Guajardo up a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a dangerous move right there. But in any other case, it's first and 10 for the Bears. Empty backfield for Guajardo as the play clock approaches 10 seconds. We're under 5 minutes left to go here in the first half. And Guajardo's looking right. It looks like he wants to run with it, but can't find anybody. Now he's got a man wide open. This is number 21 making the catch. And finally forced out of bounds. Oscar Salas forcing the receiver out of bounds. That was Nathan Miranda.
And that was beautiful, Isaac. You know, Guajardo the whole time was looking up the middle to his right. Number 21 for the Bears finally on the left side gets wide open.
And there we see Trey Guajardo kind of tricking. He looks like he wants to run. As he keeps bringing that ball down, finally finds a receiver open, completely open. And there we see Nathan Miranda making his way. And now this is a handoff to Almaguer. And Almaguer gets back to the line of scrimmage for no gain. And that'll make it second and 10. Four receivers set now for Guajardo. Guajardo takes a snap. He's looking left, rolling out to his left. Now he's going to keep this one and run. Gets it inside the 20, down to about the 14. But another flag thrown.
Holding number 76 for the offense. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
Yeah, that'll bring back another good solid run for the Bears. That's third and fourth holding penalty on the evening for that offensive front.
That one called on the left tackle, Nathaniel Herrera, and you see him trying to plead his case to the ref.
Yeah, he said he pancaked his man, but I guess he had too much jersey when he did it. A flag was thrown in. Instead of getting around into the 10-yard line, the Bears are pushed back a bit, and it's going to be second and very long.
Here's Guajardo, takes a snap. He's looking left, pump fakes, fires this one into the direction of Galvillo, and it's nearly caught, but through the fingertips.
And it's unfortunate for the Bears. That should have been a touchdown. Galvillo just couldn't hang on to the ball. And then we got some equipment that, you know, it's just too close to the football field. I'm not sure why it's there. It's inside the first lane of the track. They definitely got to move that stuff out of there.
We will not start the game until we remove the
Yes, and, you know,
the ref has spoken.
I agree totally.
Absolutely. That somebody could have gotten hurt right there.
There is no reason for the receiver, you know, hurdles those obstacles. The defender, of course, trying to defend the receiver and the ball, unfortunately didn't. And, you know, he came down hard on the track. So
third and 20 after the incomplete pass. And this is going to be a handoff to Almaguer. And Almaguer inside the 30 down to about the original line of scrimmage, all the way down to about the 25. He's finally brought down by number 80. That's Christian Villalobos, the senior defensive lineman.
And now we have one of those other calls. Now this time the Bears, you know, it's fourth down. They're at the Chiefs 26. They got a little bit of breeze. Actually, it's a pretty strong breeze on their back, but it appears they're going to elect to go for it.
Fourth and 12. Play clock inside 10 seconds, and it looks like Marroquin is going to take his second time out of the half.
Bears.
Yeah, I think Guajardo was up there just trying to draw him offside, maybe get a cheap 5 yards out of it. But instead, a standstill, and Marroquin forced to call a timeout. And let's see what they're thinking about right now. It's, if they're at the 29, that would be about a 45, 46-yard field goal.
Well, right now they're at the 26.
Oh, 26, excuse me. About a 42-yard field goal then. 41, 42-yard field goal.
42, 43.
Mm-hmm.
With a good wind, though. But
yeah, it's more southeast, you know, than anything. So it might cut into the ball, maybe push it down a little bit. It's not right behind their back by any means.
And it looks like it's going to be the offense making their way back to the field on fourth and 12.
And, of course, the other thing you got to consider, there's 2 minutes and 54 seconds. The Chiefs only have one timeout. So, yeah, I think it's worth a gamble here to go for it. Try to pick up the first down, if not pin the Chiefs deep in their own territory.
Four receiver set for Guajardo. Takes the snap. He's rolling out to his left and fires this one out to Anthony Dunaway. And it falls incomplete.
Yeah, I think
that's incomplete.
That play was just a little bit too slow in developing. He tried to hit Dunaway, he got it to him, but a little bit too late, just enough time for the defender to bat it down. Incomplete pass. And early on in the play, number four,
Gus Calvillo
was wide open. Unfortunately, he was still running his route. If he would have turned around, Guajardo was in great position to get him the football. That would have definitely been enough for a first down, but he took a deeper route, I guess, clearing the inside for Dunaway.
And here's Sines with his first pass, and this one goes out of bounds. That was intended for number 23, Oscar Lucio. And so that'll bring up second down. Ball at the 26-yard line.
Yeah, this is the Chiefs' fifth possession of the evening. Right now they've only mustered 7 first downs in the first half. Bear defense clamping down after a big run to open up the game.
And here's Sines handing this one off to the running back. This is Gutierrez, and Gutierrez finds a huge hole and finally forced out of bounds by number 7. That was Gabriel Espinosa, but a huge first down pickup for the Chiefs. It's a huge first down run. They still get to save their timeout because he was forced out of bounds.
Yes, he was, and that carries them over midfield. They're at the Bears' 43-yard line. So just like that, one play later, the Chiefs are making some noise. Of course, they still got to travel 43 yards in 2.5 minutes with one timeout remaining before the half.
First and 10, ball at the 43. Sines takes the snap, fakes the handoff, tries to avoid the pressure, and finally brought down at the 40-yard line. Avoids the sack and turns it into a 3-yard gain.
Yeah, good defensive pressure right there by the Bears defensive front. Their secondary did a good job covering the receivers. Sines smartly gets what he can. He picks up 3 yards.
Sines takes a snap, pitches this one out to the running back. This is Ochoa getting the carry, huge hole. And he's gonna go into the end zone for a 40-yard touchdown run.
And Ochoa with his second touchdown run, both big time runs. You know, we haven't seen Ochoa run the ball that much lately, and his first touchdown came for 72 yards. That one for 40.
yards just on 2 carries alone. Of course, he has had a few more carries than that, but as you did say, this whole second quarter, we didn't see a whole lot of Ochoa out there.
He has 4 carries for about 120 yards, and of course, 2 of them come on a 72-yarder and a 40-yarder.
And the extra point is good. Looked a little like it might have been blocked at the line of scrimmage, but it still makes its way through the uprights. And so with 1:51 left to go here in the first half, our score here at PSJ Stadium, it's the PSJ Bears 14, the Donna Chiefs 14.
Donna North Chiefs. Hard to get used to, right?
You know, just a little bit.
You always think of Donna, you know, Donna Redskins. And now you got the Chiefs throwing a North in between. And when you put it all together, it gets Donna North Chiefs. But it just, I don't know, it just doesn't sound right. I don't like it.
So with 1:51 left to go here in the first half, Chiefs getting ready to kick this one off to the Bears, who still have 1 timeout remaining.
Yeah, they got plenty of time. 1:51. They got 1 timeout. And they got a dual credit quarterback in Trey Guajardo that can hurt you with his legs. He's got a good target in Anthony Dunaway. We've seen it before tonight. They've already completed 2 passes for about 60 yards. So plenty of time for the Bears. No need to panic. Of course, it's a 14-14 tie. The Bears would love to go into the half with a lead.
And here's the kick from the Chiefs. And this one goes out of bounds. And so this one should be 1st and 10 for the Bears at their own 30.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, good starting field position right there. No time expired really from the
legal
clock.
Legal procedure by the kicking team. Ball will be placed at the 30-yard line. PSJA Bears football.
You know, this is the Bears' 5th possession. In 4 possessions, they've attained already 17 first downs. So they've moved the ball. They moved the ball at will, up and down. The last 2 possessions, of course, they were turnovers on downs as the Donna North Chiefs defense rose to the occasion and stopped them.
So it'll be 1st and 10 now for the Bears. They have it at their own 30. Empty backfield set for Guajardo. Galvio, the man in motion. He'll take it on a jet sweep, tries to take it up the middle. Breaks a few tackles and finally brought down at about the 35 by number 2, Oscar Salas. Meanwhile, clock ticking down to about 1:35. Bears still have 1 timeout remaining.
Yeah, they're quickly to the line of scrimmage. Plenty of time, though. 1.5 remaining in the first half.
Almaguer, the man in motion. He'll get it on a jet sweep. Picks up enough yards for the first down. Near midfield, appears to be stopped at about the 47.
Mm-hmm. Just shy of midfield. Big time run right there by Calvillo. He stays in bounds, so the clock will stop momentarily till the chain gang gets a setup there.
Now the clock ticks. Guajardo takes a snap. He's rolling out to his left. He wants to run this one. Has a lot of room. Crosses the 40. And finally brought down at about the 37. That was C.J. Castillo making the tackle.
Yeah, good run right there. Take what the defense will give you. Good job by Guajardo.
Guajardo takes the snap, hands this one off to Almaguer, who stumbles near the line of scrimmage. Still picks up about 2 yards. Now clock ticking down to about 38 seconds.
Yeah, I'm not too happy about that play right there. You know, you run it up the middle. There's no way of stopping the clock unless you're going to use your final timeout of the half.
And this one thrown in the direction of Anthony Dunaway, but wasn't able to get a clean break at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, exactly. Great job by the defense right there. Holding them at the line of scrimmage, not letting them release. The timing was way off. Guajardo fires it, but no one in the area. That brings up a 3rd and 8 for the Bears at the Chiefs' 34-yard line with a little bit over 26 seconds remaining in the first half in a 14-14 tie.
Guajardo takes a snap. He's rolling out to his right. Tries to avoid the pressure and does. And this one thrown to Almaguer, but he takes a huge hit in his midsection.
Once again, you don't want to make that pass. You know, ill-advised pass. You hung up your receiver to dry right there. Could have easily been picked off. Hopefully, if it is Almaguer, I hope he's all right. I believe it is. He took a shot right in the midsection. I'm sure he's out of breath. And you hear a lot of oohs and ahs from the crowd.
It was a big hit, and if Almaguer has to sit out for a few plays, that's going to hurt the Bear offense because, like we said, we haven't seen Mark Castillo back out there.
Not at all. Yeah, they definitely need him. He's the go-to guy right now. We've seen him do a lot of jet sweeps, and this time they try to hit him in the flat, and unfortunately, the ball was a little bit too high. The defender had great positioning, came in, and, basically – he laid the lumber on him. You know, that's what you're trained to do as a defensive back. You know, go attack, make a play, and he did. Let's just hope our Bear receiver running back, Almaguer, is all right.
He's still being tended to by the trainers. And hopefully it's nothing more than, maybe the air being knocked out.
That's what I believe it is. I think he got, he got cut in half, if you will, right there. Just a big blow.
And now we see Almaguer walking off, so a good thing to see. Hopefully it's nothing too serious, and we can see him back out there for this PSJA offense.
Yeah, I think he's going to be all right. We probably won't see him again until the second half. Of course, it is going to be 4th down and 8 for the Bears, just inside the 35-yard line of the Chiefs with 18.9 seconds. Of course, the clock does stop if there is a first down. And the Bears still...
We got a timeout. Timeout. Bears.
I was going to say the Bears still have one more timeout, but they elect to use it.
They're going to want to talk things over on this fourth down play. Mm-hmm. They need 8 yards for the first down with 18.9 seconds.
Left. The Chiefs have 0.
You know, I thought that because earlier in the game he had said that the Chiefs had used their second timeout, but they marked it off for the Bears.
Right, right. And I was just going off the scoreboard. So.
Yeah, I was too. I'm glad somebody's paying attention, though.
Mm-hmm. So good call right there by the head official, making sure the Bears still have that one extra timeout remaining. But still... regardless of how many timeouts you have left, the key issue here is you need to pick up 8 yards in order to keep this drive going. It's 4th and 8, 14-14 tie. Few seconds remaining in the first half in a very well-played football game. I think two football teams that are equally matched.
So here we go on 4th and 8. Well, Guajardo takes a snap. He's looking left. Fires this one into the direction of Calvillo. And it's tipped by the defender.
Great effort. Last second tip. Can't tell who that was.
I think that was Oscar Salas.
Yes, I do believe it was.
And if it wasn't him, then it was Alex Gonzalez, one of the two young men there.
Yeah, Calvillo was streaking down the sideline. It looked like Guajardo put just enough air to get it to him for a touchdown. And instead, it's batted away at the last second. And the Chiefs will take over. They'll take over with 12.5 seconds remaining in the first half.
Now, the scoreboard says the Chiefs have one timeout, right, but the official has already said they have zero timeouts.
I think they transposed those. And that should be it, regardless of how many timeouts we have going into the half.
Because the Chiefs decide to kneel this one. And that's going to take us into halftime. Ladies and gentlemen, our score at PSJ Stadium, it's the Bears 14, the Chiefs 14. We'll be right back after halftime. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are back from halftime, and what an exciting first half of football it was. This contest is between the PSJA Bears and the Donna North Chiefs. We still have a tied score, 14 apiece. And in the first half, the Donna North Chiefs had a total of 258 yards of total offense, 243 which came on the ground. And of the 243, it was Ochoa who had 120 yards, I think it was, what, on four carries?
Exactly, four carries.
Then you have the Bears, who had 240 yards of total offense, 106 yards passing behind the arm of Trey Wahalgo, who also has 86 yards rushing.
It's been a, you know, the yards tell the story. It's been very evenly matched. The one thing that stands out to me, though, Isaac, you know, Donna North only has 9 first downs in the first half, meaning they had a lot of big plays. The Bears, on the other hand, have 19 first downs, meaning they've had a lot of ball control. They've driven up and down the field. Their last 3 possessions of the half ended up in turnover of down, so they've had opportunities to score, just haven't been able to capitalize. And I think that's exactly what's going to happen here in the second half. And of course, we're tied 14-14. It comes down to 24 minutes, and I think the team who capitalizes the most here in the second half is definitely going to come up with a big win here on opening night.
It was an exciting, well-played first half. Mm-hmm. Let's hope for the same here in the second as the Bears get ready to receive the opening kickoff here in the second half. Number 4, Gus Calvillo, and number 20, that's Almaguer, back to receive the kick here for the Bears.
And it's good to see Almaguer back. He took a punishing hit towards the latter part of the second quarter.
And Almaguer gets to the 30, right around down to about the 34. He's brought down by number 5, Victor Aguirre. And as you said, Javi, it's a good thing to see Almaguer back out there on the field. They're going to need him for the rest of this game. Still no word on Mark Castillo. He's been kind of pacing around the sidelines, not too sure what happened. We hadn't seen him since their first offensive series.
Mm-hmm. He's been on the sideline without a helmet, kind of limping a little bit, favoring either one leg or the other. Not sure what it is. We're not going to speculate on it either. But in either case, you know, the Bears got to step it up with what they have on the field, and so far they've done a good job of it.
First and 10, ball on the 35. 4 receivers set for Wahardo. He takes the snap, hands this one off to the running back. That's Almaguer getting the carry, and he gets it down to about the 44. That was number 10, Ruben Garza, making a tackle there for the Chiefs. And it appears Almaguer does have enough. He might be maybe a yard short.
Yeah, he may be just inside the 45, which is a yard line they have to get to. They may measure. No indication yet. Chains haven't moved. And he may be an inch or two away from the first down. So second and inches for the Bears.
As you said, Javi, ball is inside the 44-yard line. Bears almost caught the Chiefs jumping off sides, but here's the handoff to Almaguer. Has enough for the first down. He crosses midfield, brought down by number 24, Arif Martinez.
Yeah, the first 2 plays, the Bears come out running the ball with Almaguer. Both times just off the tackle. Great blocking at the point of attack by the Bears offensive line. And the end result's a first down, and just like that, 2 plays later, the Bears have already moved into the Chiefs' side of the football field. First and 10 for the Bears at the Chiefs' 46-yard line.
Wahardo takes a snap. It's another handoff to Almaguer, and Almaguer is met in the backfield by number 80 and number 99. That's Christian Villalobos and Josimar Pina. And looks to be about a gain about, they're going to say he gained 1 yard.
Yeah, the Bears have had 3 plays, all three off of the right tackle. This time the Chiefs were more than ready for it, held them to just a yard. You see the Bears mix it up a bit and attack another side of the defensive front of the Chiefs.
Four receiver set for the Bears. Bojardo takes the snap, fakes the handoff, takes this one himself, breaks a few tackles, gets inside the 40, still on his feet, has a big hole. He's at the 20, the 10, the 5. That's a touchdown, a 45-yard touchdown run by the sophomore quarterback, Trey Bojardo.
And that's his second touchdown of the game. His first one was a 3-yard jolt. This time, 45 yards. A little razzle-dazzle. Took off to the left side this time, off tackle. Turned it upfield, then it was a race to the end zone, and by far he was clearly the fastest man on the football field. Easy touchdown right there for the Bears.
So that 45-yard touchdown run by Bojardo makes the score here. PSJA 20, Chiefs 14. We are in the middle of the extra point attempt here by the Bears. The kick is up and it appears to be through the uprights. The extra point is good. And with that 45-yard run, the Bears have a 7-point lead over the Chiefs, 21-14 with 10 minutes and 12 seconds left to go here in the third quarter.
And you couldn't have asked for a better start.
Here we see on the replay, Trey Bojardo putting on a few moves. Nice juke move right there. Cuts it back to the right side, and it was just off to the races. No one was going to catch him. A nice 45-yard run there by Trey Bojardo, giving his team a nice little cushion here in the opening drive here in the second half. So now we have number 23, Jonathan Figueroa, the junior kicker, getting ready to kick this one off. We have number 16, I don't have a 16 on my roster, but this one's going to be fielded right about the 5-yard line. And this is going to be returned to the 30. Finally forced out of bounds by the kicker, Figueroa. Puts the nice hit. That was number 24 on the return, Martinez. And Martinez gets it all the way down to about the 37-yard line.
So just as the first half started, Isaac, you know, we got some fireworks already here in the second half. And in the first half, when the first game just started, we said, you know, possibly it could be a defensive game, low-scoring game. Quickly, 14 points were scored within the first 5 minutes. After that, it's been a defensive struggle, just as we thought. But the Bears come out quickly to open up the second half to build a 21-14 lead.
Sines takes the snap, hands this one off to Ochoa. Ochoa bounces it to the outside. Met in the backfield, but second effort gets him about 2, maybe 3 yards on that carry. Took it down to about the 39. As he's brought down by number 99, J.J. Barrientes. That makes it second and 8 now for the Chiefs.
Yeah, good start right there by the Bear defense, holding the Chiefs to only 2 yards. Of course, Ochoa has two big runs of 40 and 72 for touchdowns in the first half.
Second and 8, high snap, Sines catches it. He's gonna run this one himself. Tries to go down the left. Breaks a couple of tackles, and all that dancing around only got him 1 yard.
Yeah, that high snap just disrupted the whole timing of the play. The defense gets good penetration, seals it off, nowhere for the quarterback to run. Good defensive stop, and the Bears offense came out on fire, scoring a touchdown.
There we see on the replay, and you know, it's just like you say, a high snap can really disrupt the flow of the play. It doesn't really get a chance to start because, I mean, he's jumping for that snap, and all of a sudden he comes back down. He's already got defenders in his face.
Yeah, so here's a big opportunity for the Bears defense to shine, just as the offense did to start here the third quarter.
Third and 7, here's Sines with the fake. Fires this one out to Gutierrez, his running back. Picks up a first down, breaks some tackles. And finally brought down by number 34.
Number 22, Mark Gutierrez.
Ezekiel Marroquin. but it's going to be good enough for a first down. I believe that's a pickup of 15 yards.
Yep. Big play on third down executed by the Chiefs. Bears are hoping to stuff them, force them to punt, possibly even a turnover, but instead the Chiefs come through. Good pass and catch. Good yards after the reception. And the Chiefs, just like that, a couple plays later, they're inside the Bears side of the football field.
First and 10, ball at the 43-yard line. Sines takes a snap, hands this one out to Ochoa. He's got a lot of running room up the middle, breaking some tackles. Takes some good hits as he's finally brought down by number 12, Jose Garza, and number 35, Raul Segura. And Ochoa appears to be very close, and yes, they're going to say he does have a first down.
Up exactly 10 yards, exactly what it needed. And tell you what, Ochoa got belted a couple times. Good swarming defense by the Bears. Unfortunately, it was 10 yards downfield. They got to do a better job of containing the run at the line of scrimmage.
And here is Gutierrez with the carry, breaking tackles, has another first down as he makes his way inside the 20, still on his feet.
That's
and he just took that whole pile, another 5 yards, inside down to the 14.
That's his pure guts and determination by that running back at Donna North. And the Bears are battling with a 3 defensive linemen, sometimes 4. It's just your linebackers aren't filling up the gaps, filling up the holes, and that's allowing the Donna North Chiefs to pick up good chunks of yards every time they get the ball.
And here's Gutierrez once again up the middle. A.J. Gomez, number 16 in on the action.
Yeah, much better effort right there by the Bears. Stuffing the run, not allowing the ball carrier to get any head of steam. Knocking them down. Although they did get 1 yard, but they limited it to just 1 yard. Brings up a 2nd and 9.
2nd and 9, ball on the 13-yard line. Just under 7 minutes left to go here in the third quarter. Sines takes the snap, fakes the handoff. He's rolling out to his left. He's going to run this one himself. Gets inside the 10, inside the 5, dives to the pylon.
I don't think he got there.
And he's just short. Forced out of bounds.
And he may be a little bit banged up, slow to get up. They're going to mark him inside the 1 yard line. Great effort. Great fake. I thought the ball was given to the running back around the right side. The whole defense was fooled. The quarterback rambles around the left side, tries to sneak in. Was held short, though. He took a beating, though.
He sure did. He dove head first. Mm-hmm.
He took the brunt of that hit. And I believe he's coming out for a play.
Timeout, Chiefs.
Yeah, and that's a smart timeout by the Chiefs. The timeout allows that injured player to re-enter the game.
He won't have to sit out.
Exactly, because, I mean, he got walloped. He was attempting to score, try to tie the game up, or at least get within one. Good defensive play by the Bears to keep him from getting into the end zone. But nonetheless, it'll be first and goal for the Chiefs as they trail the Bears 21-14 with 6:46 remaining in the third quarter.
Looks like it might be his left ankle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he might have rolled it a little bit when he got hit. Of course, he got hit in the upper body, but you know, playing in this turf, he may have rolled it a bit.
Bears defense back on the field as they're awaiting for the Chiefs to return from their timeout. They're still all gathered up.
Yeah, the Bears are ready to go, knowing full well their quarterback is banged up. They want to get out there, hurry up. And here finally the referee says, that's enough is enough. Let's get out here. Whether you have your starting quarterback or not, I can't tell if he's in there.
I think he's still in there.
He is jogging very gingerly. Yeah, he is back in there. Tough man, Alex Sines.
Sines takes a snap. He's going to take this one himself. And he's in the end zone for a touchdown from 1 yard out. Snaps it, goes right behind his center. and he's in for the touchdown. And the Chiefs are down 20-21 as they get ready to attempt the extra point.
And the Chiefs answer back with a 63-yard drive of their own. As you mentioned, they're pending the extra point to tie the game up. We have a seesaw battle going on right now. It's two teams that are very evenly matched.
The way the second half has started, it could turn into one of those games. It's whoever has the ball
exactly,
last.
Exactly, yes. And that's where we're headed. And it's kind of an awkward game. You know, at times they move the ball at will, but then you get these crucial penalties that deflate the drive, and that's been the story for both teams. But even then, 21-21, it's been a very entertaining game halfway into the third quarter. Still plenty of football to go. The Bears will be receiving, and you're exactly right, Isaac. You know, it may be one of those nights, whoever has the ball last is going to score that last touchdown or kick a field goal to end up victorious.
6 minutes and 41 seconds left to go here in the third. Chiefs getting ready to kick this one off and back to return for the Bears. Once again, it's going to be Almaguer and Calvillo as they set up inside their own 10-yard line. Now here come the Chiefs getting ready. Yeah, I think we're gonna get a flag here.
Yeah, that's
Delay of game here.
Delay of game on the kicking team. You don't see too many of those happen, but.
Delay of game by the Chiefs, that's a 5-yard penalty.
And I was about to say, well, excuse me, Mr. Referee. I was about to say they're being very deliberate on their kickoff. And that cost them 5 yards. So.
I don't know if they were trying to play mind games.
I really don't know. You know, they waited for the two end guys to get all the way to the sideline, and then they broke very slowly. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know what they're trying to do, but nonetheless, they're going to attempt it again.
Now they're kicking from their own 35. Here's the kick. Calvillo lets this one roll into the back.
Well, they knew what they were doing. I guess he needed those 5 extra yards to make sure he got in the end zone.
That was close. That one nearly rolled out right before it went in.
From 25 yard line.
From our angle, it looked like it went out
just before
the pylon, which means it would have been a penalty. And the Bears would have got the ball at the
30.
So it's not that big of a difference. I think they lose
five
yards. So, but then again, they could have forced them to kick it again from the 30-yard line.
30-yard line.
Yeah, and after sprinting down about 60 yards, that would have been a very tired coverage team. But nonetheless, you know, it's a game of inches. The Bears set up shop at the 25.
First and 10, Guajardo takes a snap, hands this one off to Almaguer. And Almaguer's brought down right around the line of scrimmage. Loses one. That was number 33 making the play there, Jerry Chavez.
And again, the North defense, the Chiefs with a 4-man defensive front, 2 linebackers.
And here's Almaguer taking this one, has a lot of great blocking, putting on the spin moves, still on his feet, has the flag thrown.
Yeah, nice shifty running there by Almaguer, picking up an extra 10, 15 yards after contact. We see a flag thrown. Almaguer tackled at about the 48-yard line, a flag at about the 38-yard line.
Now they're gonna call holding against the Bears.
Okay.
But where the flag was thrown.
Yeah, that was past the first down.
Past the first down marker.
Right, so.
Block in the back, number 2 for the offense. 10-yard penalty, repeat the down, second down.
So it looks like we might just redo the down.
They actually pick up maybe a couple yards. Yeah, they're gonna
Yeah.
Yeah, because they were about 3 yards past the first down. They were at about the 38. They have to get to 35, so kind of doesn't make any sense. But
it really doesn't. I mean, it was called correctly.
Yeah.
The yardage was correct.
Right.
But it's just one of those situations where they committed a penalty, but it still worked out in their favor.
Yes. Passing completed that time. Positive yards. That time the ball flutters away from Mojarlo trying to hit Dunaway. She sails into the Bears bench.
And that incomplete pass will make it 3rd and 7 with the ball at the 28-yard line with 5 minutes and 46 seconds.
You know, it's strange, Isaac. You know, the first possession of each team, it was, man, hurry, 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 let's get it down the field. Now it's a slower pace and taking a whole different atmosphere in the ballgame. Like, everything slowed down.
3rd down, Guajardo fires this one for Calvillo, and it's intercepted by number 14, Alex Gonzalez. That pass was headed for Gus Calvillo.
Yeah, Gus Calvillo had the defender beat by a good 3-4 yards. Unfortunately, the ball was underthrown. Great defensive effort right there, but missed opportunity right there for the Bears. He lays it out there a few more yards, and maybe Calvillo comes up with the catch.
So it'll be turnover for the Bears, and the Chiefs will have it at their own 47-yard line. 5.5 minutes left to go here in the third, as we're still tied 21 apiece.
And that is the second turnover forced by the Chiefs tonight. I believe both of them are on interceptions.
And here's Gutierrez, who's getting the carry. Looks to get back right to the line of scrimmage as he's brought down by number 45, Kane Rodriguez. And that'll make it 2nd and 10. As we see here on the replay, Gutierrez tries to go up the middle, and Rodriguez was right there ready to meet him, and he brings him down for no gain. So a great defensive play there by Rodriguez and the Bears, making it 2nd and 10, just under 5 minutes left here in the third. Signs under center, takes the snap, fakes the handoff. He's rolling left, tries to find a receiver, and he's going to throw this one out of bounds.
Yeah, great lateral pursuit by the defensive front and linebacker. So the Bears not giving the quarterback any chance to complete that. Good coverage by the secondary. Quarterback wisely just throws that away. Brings up a 3rd down.
That was Ezekiel Marroquin putting the pressure there on Alex Sines, forcing Sines to throw the ball away. And bringing up 3rd and 10 with the ball still placed at the Chief 37.
That would be a great opportunity right here for the Bears to shut down the Chiefs, force a punt, possibly even a turnover of their own, and get the ball right back into their offensive hands.
Sines takes the snap, hands this one off to Ochoa, and Ochoa's met at the line of scrimmage, breaking tackles, and he gets positive yards.
Wow.
That was an impressive run there by Ochoa.
That's some of the hardest 5 yards I've ever seen gained by somebody. Got hit right at the line of scrimmage, actually got pushed backwards, and then still raced upfield, picked about, 6-7 yards right there, Isaac?
Wow, that was just a great run.
Yeah,
finally number 12, Jose Garza, forcing him out.
They're going to say he picked up 5, but that's a 5 very hard-earned yards right there.
And it looks like the Chiefs will be punting as they want to pin the Bears deep into their own territory. And here's the punt by the Chiefs. Bounces into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. So the Bears will take over at their own 25-yard line. Excuse me, the 20-yard line. So the defense, after a Trey Wahadlo interception, was able to hold their ground, not give up any big plays, not give up a first down.
Yeah, that was huge on the defense right there, getting a big defensive stop, especially after giving up a touchdown on their first possession.
It was a great job. You know, the Chiefs really had a lot of momentum working. Yep. They had just scored that touchdown, then they come up with an interception.
Yeah, the game could have turned very quickly. Solid effort right there by the Bears. Let's see if their offense can get going again. Of course, on the first possession, 66-yard drive capped off by a big run by Guajardo to give them the lead.
And here's the carry by Mark Castillo, who hadn't seen any action since the first offensive series. He's brought down by number 70 in the backfield. That was Jesus Costilla. And that's going to be a 2-yard loss for Castillo. And he's making his way back to the sideline.
Right, they're going
to
bring back Almaguer. I'm not sure what's going on with Castillo. He wasn't happy about coming out of the ball game, that's for sure.
Guajardo takes the snap, fakes the handoff to Almaguer. He's going to keep this one himself, takes it up the middle, has running room, has the first down, and more. Still on his feet, crosses midfield, going down the sideline, and wisely steps out of bounds because he was running out of room to run.
Yeah, but great run right there. Good blocking by the offense. But that's Guajardo right there, getting into open space, utilizing his speed, his quickness, his agility, and just bolting down the right sideline.
Here we see on the replay a design run by Guajardo. Cuts it up the middle, then decides to take it to his right and just turns on the jets, finally being forced out of bounds by number 2 and 14, Oscar Salas and Alex Gonzalez. First and 10. Here's Guajardo, hands this one off to Almaguer. Almaguer tries to get around the edge, has room, gets to the 30, but another flag is thrown right around the 40-yard line. And generally, that's going to be a holding penalty. We still have 3 minutes and 36.
Number 76 for the offense. Second down.
Once again, 3 minutes and 36 seconds left to go here in the third. Bears putting on a nice drive here. It started off at their own 20. A big run by Trey Guajardo on second and 12. Had it taken all the way to the 40-yard line. But now a holding penalty is going to bring them all the way back to midfield. It'll make it first and 20.
Yeah, that's a big penalty once again. Those are drive killers, those holding penalties, those chop block penalties. Let's see if the Bears can overcome. Right now they've been riding the legs of Guajardo, who has over 170 yards rushing on the evening.
Guajardo takes a snap, hands this one off to Almaguer. Almaguer has room, wide open space, puts a move on the defender. He's inside the 20. Oscar Salas finally making the tackle at about the 15-yard line. And on first and 20, Almaguer picks up about 30.
That was about 34 yards right there. Great burst of speed. Great blocking by that offensive line.
Here we see on the replay, Almaguer turning on the jets, throws a move right there on Gonzalez.
I would have liked to have seen them cut it to the outside, though. Instead of cut right back in.
And here's Guajardo taking it up the middle, gets inside the 10-yard line, finally brought down at the 8. Gain of 8 yards on that run. That was number 14 making the tackle, Alex Gonzalez. And that makes it 2nd and 2 for the Bears. They have it at their own, at the Donna Chief 8-yard line. Just a little over 2 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. Guajardo is taking the snap, fakes the hands off, gets stopped at the line of scrimmage, puts a spin move, and is able to pick up about a yard until he's stopped by number 40, Gus Escalante.
Yeah, a little bit of indecision right there by Guajardo, whether they give it to Almaguer or not. He decides to keep it. Nothing going up the middle, though. Good defensive stop by the Chiefs and brings up a very big third and short for the Bears at the Chiefs' 7-yard line.
Third and 1. 3 receivers set for Guajardo. He'll take the snap, fakes the handoff. He's going to run this one himself up the middle. Second effort gets him into the end zone for a touchdown, his third rushing touchdown of the game.
He caps off an 80-yard drive, only 3 first downs, a lot of big plays on that drive.
And the electrifying sophomore gets into the end zone for the third time, putting his team up 27-21 as we still await the extra point. With a minute and 32 seconds left to go here in the third quarter, here's Figueroa getting ready to attempt the extra point. There's the snap, hold is down, the kick is up and through the uprights. So a 28-21 is the score between the PSJA Bears and the Donna North Chiefs. We still have a minute and 32 seconds left here in the third quarter.
Great effort.
It was a great drive there by the Bears. Started off at their own 20. And here we'll see it again on the replay. Guajardo with that fake on the jet sweep takes this one himself up the middle. Gets stuffed there at the about the 1 yard line, but then his second effort gets him into the end zone. And Guajardo's putting on a show here tonight.
Yes, he is. He's a real deal. He's just a sophomore, as we've mentioned a few times already. You know, he came in late in the season. Was moved up from the freshman team last year as a freshman, of course. Played about 7 games on the freshman team. Came in the last 3-4 games for the varsity. Did extremely well. And he's picking up right where he left off. And I think the Bears have something special in Guajardo, especially since he is just a sophomore. So there's a lot to build around Guajardo right there. The Bears offense right now have put up 28 points. That's something they weren't able to do last year. Consistently score points. This year they're doing a much better job of moving the football and more importantly retaining it, although they have 2 turnovers tonight.
Here's the kick by Figueroa, filled it at the 5-yard line by number 24. That's Martinez on the return. He gets up to the 30. Finally brought down at about the 35. Number 16, AJ Gomez making the tackle.
Yeah, great job by AJ Gomez, just staying at home on the far side. Waiting, sitting it out, and finally clips the return man. If he gets past him, might be good night. But instead, he makes a good tackle, good saving tackle. And Donna North will set up at their own 41-yard line.
And here comes the Donna North offense. First down, ball on the 36-yard line. Signs under center, takes the snap. Hands one this to the running back. This is Ochoa getting the carry. Ochoa just breaking tackles left and right. Picks up about 3, maybe 4 yards before he's stopped by number 35, Raul Segura. A tough 3-yard pickup there by Ochoa.
Yeah, there's no doubt that he is a very physical runner. The Bears got their hands full trying to stop him, but they're doing a much better job here in the second half. That four-man defensive front is playing outstanding football right now.
And here's the handoff to Gutierrez, who tries to take this one up the middle right over the right guard. Picks up about 1 yard on that run. That was number 99 making the tackle, J.J. Barrientos, and number 45, Kane Rodriguez. And this might be the final play of the third quarter. Chiefs don't have to run a play. They can let the clock run out here, but they are going to make it to the line of scrimmage with 15 seconds.
If they like to pass it, this might be a good time to do it right before the end of the third quarter where they have the wind slightly out their back, but I don't believe they are going to get a snap off. I think they're going to be happy to only be down by 7 heading into the fourth quarter.
And that will do it for the final play of the third quarter. As we get ready for the fourth and final quarter of play, our score here at PSJ Stadium, it's the Bears 28, the Chiefs 21. Teams are switching sides of the field, getting ready to get this fourth quarter underway.
And the fourth quarter will get underway with a pretty crucial play right here. You know, third and fourth, very manageable third and four, especially the hard-nosed running that the Chiefs running backs have, but the Bears defense, they've been settling down, they've been playing much better. So a lot at stake here, you know, anybody's ball game. We got 12 minutes to go.
So here we go, third and four for the Chiefs. Here's the snap, Science takes it, pitches this one out to the running back who's met in the backfield.
That could have easily, there was no penalty. The coach over there, Donna North, is yelling and screaming. That could have very easily been a horse collar, and it may have, could have been, because it appears the ball carrier is hurt.
He is grabbing his right ankle. And that's the common injury when you tend to be tackled, you know, by the collar of your shoulder pads.
By the shoulder pads, you kind of roll underneath him, take his legs out. And no, okay, there we go. Late flag, I guess. That's a proper call. I mean, you know.
It did look like a horse collar tackle.
It was. Unfortunately, the referee crew looks a little shady, you know, a little shaky on that, if you will, because they didn't do it when they were supposed to call it, but.
So now Marroquin is upset that it's thrown so late.
Because he's so late, yes.
And, I mean, rightfully so. You can be upset because it's a late flag, but, you know, it is the right call.
And, of course, the play was run towards the Donna North sideline, which they had the best vantage view. We're on the opposite side.
Personal foul. Horse collar. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
And the argument can be he didn't have him by the shoulder pads. He only had him by the jersey. But if you have him in that area and roll him backwards – and use your body as leverage to bring him down, that is a horse collar. And, you know, I think, you know, we're all, you know, of course, we're here at PSJA Stadium, and we hope the Bears can pull this one out. Of course, they have a 28-21 lead, but, you know, fair is fair, and I think the right call was made on the field.
So here we go, first and 10 after the penalty. The Chiefs have it at the PSJA 47. Sines takes the snap, hands this one off to Ochoa. Ochoa met at the line of scrimmage and just bulldozes his way for positive yards. He picks up the first down. How does this man do it? It was just...
I'm chuckling because, to be honest, I thought he was brought down at the 40. And next thing you know, he's down to the 36.
Four guys hit him at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah. At some point, though, you know, for the safety of the kids, you know, going back to that horse collar, you got to blow the play dead. You got to blow the play dead because, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on that we can't see from up here. But I tell you what, that guy's a gamer. Ochoa's one tough hombre.
Definitely a tough kid. Here's another handoff to the running back this time. It's going to be number 22 getting the carry. That's Mark Gutierrez. And that was number 73 making the tackle for the Bears. That's Eddie Gonzalez. And after the two-yard pickup by Gutierrez, it's second and 8 with the ball placed at the PSJA 34. A minute and a half already gone by in this fourth quarter. Play clock down to 10 seconds.
Chiefs getting set.
And they get the snap off. Here's the pitch out to Ochoa. Ochoa gets inside the 30, still pumping his feet.
Yeah, right now Ochoa is a defensive back's nightmare. They don't want anything to do with him.
He's finally brought down by number 55 of that PSJA defense. And that was Jacob Sanchez, but it was an 8-yard pickup. So now it's first and 10 with the ball at the PSJA 25.
Yeah, we're approaching the 10-minute mark. Remaining in the ball game. Down to North, trying to rally themselves, get themselves right back in there. Right now they're 2-7. Bears.
Oh, high snap. This was going to happen eventually. And the Bears, well, actually it's the Chiefs that catch a break and able to fall on it.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, Isaac, you're right on that. That it is about the fourth or fifth time that the center quarterback exchange has been very high. This time the Bears are fortunate that the ball does go over the sail over the quarterback's head. Of course, Donna North recovers it, but it'll be second and 27. Huge, huge break right there for that Bear defense.
Right now the ball's placed at the PSJA 42. They need to get to the 15.
Yeah, that's a long ways from here.
For a first down. Now it is only second down. Here's a snap to Sines. He's rolling out to his right. He's trying to avoid the pressure. Still has it, throws this one. And he wisely throws it away.
Another great effort right there. Two defensive linemen put solid pressure on the quarterback, chasing him out of bounds. He had nowhere to go with it. As you mentioned, wisely throws it out of bounds. But that brings up a third and long. So right here, the Bears can really either pin their ears back, get after the quarterback, or settle their secondary and just try to, you know, be out there as, so to speak, in center field and try to pick a pass off. So odds are the Bears defense will come up with a big play right here.
And do you think the approach for the Chiefs is to try to pick up as much yards here on this third?
Yes, definitely.
Possibly go for it on fourth. And here's the handoff, but it doesn't get very far. That's Gutierrez taking it down to about the 37.
Right, right. And that's the right play. You know, pick up some yards. Hope they can get something close to the first down. But right now, you know, the Chiefs are at the Bears 36-yard line. Way, they'd be kicking into the wind. That's, you know, maybe even too much of an NFL kicker to make this field goal.
Like so, a 53-yarder,
so exactly. Yeah, so they're going to punt and hope they can pin them.
Timeout, Chiefs.
And I'm not sure why they did call a timeout. I wasn't paying attention to the play clock.
I thought they had time, too, but the thing is, you know, there's way more than 8 minutes left in the game. Yes. Now the Chiefs only have one timeout, only down
right,
seven.
Right, I would have saved that timeout, and I would have punted it away. And the Bears didn't have anybody back there unless the Chiefs were lining up for a trick play. And the Bears had already sniffed it out, so they said, you know what, let's get out of here. But at that point, you know, Isaac, you know, game management, take a penalty. Five more yards isn't really going to hurt you any. You can still pin them deep.
And, you know, if you move 5 yards back, it actually puts your punter
actually,
in a better
position. Actually, it's an advantage for your punter. Exactly. You see, now the Bears are going to, after the timeout, are going to send a return man deep.
That's Almaguer inside his 10, the speedster.
So, you know, high pooch punt, and Almaguer gets a fair catch. And you know, but that's why we're up here in the booth.
Oh, my goodness. It's up. They're going to try to fire this one out, and this one's caught. Still on his feet. He hasn't been tackled down. He got it inside the 10-yard line, down at the 6.
That just should not happen. They do a reverse fake punt. The receiver was just sitting there like, you know, a sitting duck. A defensive man, I couldn't tell what number it was in position. Instead of trying to bat the ball down, he tried to intercept it. It goes through his hands. Well, you know, as they say, better be lucky than good, and that's exactly what was that. Donna North was very fortunate to pick up the first down.
On 4th and 17.
My goodness.
A gutsy call, but it pays off for the Chiefs.
Yeah, and
you know what? Maybe that timeout worked out well for them,
well,
I guess.
Well, yeah. Maybe they said, well, let's throw it to the other side.
I'll put my foot in my mouth now. Yeah. Here's the pitch to Ochoa. Tries to get around to the left side, untouched for a 6-yard touchdown run.
Wow. That is all I'm going to say about that possession. Wow.
And the Chiefs are now 1 point away from tying this game yet again. Right now it's the Bears 28, Chiefs 27. Chiefs getting ready to attempt the extra point.
And with that run, that gives Ochoa over 150 yards on the evening. So fine effort by him. His counterpart, of course, is Trey Guajardo with over 150 yards rushing on the evening as well. So good battle between two good backs. Oh, that's huge.
Oh,
they
that's
block
a big
it.
One, but they got to stop him.
Oh, you got to be kidding me once again.
And he made it
no
in there
way.
For the 2 point. No, he didn't.
Oh, he did it.
They stopped him short. They're going to say he went out of bounds.
You know what? From here, it looked like he crossed the pylon.
I thought he did. I thought
he was
dove.
In. I mean, you know.
But wait, I guess wait. When he dove,
he may have stepped out of bounds.
He may have bounds. Stepped out of bounds.
I'm glad there's not break. Instant replay in this case because it appeared he made it. I go, wow, great. They blocked it, and then, oh, no. He's going to scoot around for the on the left side and make a two-point conversion and take the lead. But instead, the Bears are clinging to a 28-27 lead here in a thrilling ball game here on opening night on Friday Night Lights.
I was just about to say, what a great way to start our Friday.
Yeah, yeah. This is an amazing game. It's two good football teams. They're getting after it, of course, as we mentioned earlier. These two teams battled these past couple years in the old 32-5A district. Donna North will remain in 32-5A. The Bears moving up to 31-6A. So it's going to be interesting. I think both teams are improved from last year.
You know, a little history in the making. This is going to be the first time that all four PSJA schools will be in the same district.
And what makes this a great district, and, you know, we're getting way ahead of ourselves. You know, of course, it's week one. We got to wait till week four. But it's PSJA ISD versus Edinburgh CISD. And, you know, there's eight teams, four respective teams on each side with four playoff spots.
And here's the onside kick. Nobody was ready for that one. The Bears weren't. Clearly, the Bears were not ready for that one. But they caught a break because that one went about 5 yards.
And I, you know, I tell you what, they gambled on that punt. They succeeded. It's too early to onside kick. You know, you're down by one. Take your chances. You know, get a stop. At worst, the Bears score, make an extra point. Donna North can always come back, go for two. But at this point now, I don't know what the rule is because the ball went out.
It didn't even cross midfield.
It went out at the 42. Normally, when the ball goes out of bounds, it goes to the 30-yard line.
Well, normally when they kick it, it crosses the 50.
Yes, that's what I mean. So the Bears may just take it where it went out of bounds, which
I think that's what's going to happen.
And the strangest part is
illegal procedure by the kicking team. Ball goes out of bounds at the 45-yard line. We'll assess a 5-yard penalty. First and 10, PSJA Bears at the 40-yard line.
You know, hey, I'm all for it. The Bears have 40 yards to go. But I don't understand this high school. You know, the funny thing is, Isaac, I've always wondered. The ball goes out of bounds or on the kickoff, it goes to the 30. If it goes into the end zone, it goes to the 25. If a punt goes into the end zone, it goes to the 20. I don't know. I mean, very interesting. But, hey, it's high school football at its best here on Friday night.
And it's definitely made the game that much more interesting. Oh, now we have a fumble snap.
It. What in the world?
It's still loose, but it looks like the Chiefs have recovered
it. Yeah, that was just a mix-up in the backfield. Well, Hoddle went one way. The running back went the exact same way. So, you know, throw out that onside kick. I mean, hey, the Bears just gift-wrapped the ball back to Donna North. You know, the Bears, you know, that's a maturity part of it. You know, you got a young team, although, you know, you got your whole offensive line coming back. You got some youngsters coming back. You know, although, you know, they got some playing time last year. They weren't successful last year, you know, only winning one game. This is where, calm them down, say, hey, look, gentlemen, we got the game in hand. Let's put a clinching drive right here, take a 2-touchdown lead, and it's ours. It's it on very first down. They cough it up, and here we go again. It's a 1-point lead, and it's anybody's ball game.
First and 10 for the Chiefs. They have it at their own 34-yard line. Sines takes the snap, hands this one off to the running back. That's Gutierrez getting the carry. And he's stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Making the tackle was number 70, Roman Garza. A junior defensive lineman. He's had himself quite a good game tonight. We've called his name out a few times. And that'll make it 2nd and 11.
Yes, the Bears defense has settled down. They're starting to minimize the big gains by the running backs and the passing game of the Chiefs. And right now, it's going to be a game of will. Whoever wants this game more is going to end up in the W.
And Sines going to take this one on the quarterback keeper. It was a good fake to Gutierrez. Even I got faked that. I thought Gutierrez was about to get stopped in the backfield. Then you just see Sines picking up a few yards. He's finally brought down by number 34 of that PSJA defense.
Yeah, and Sines has been the workhorse for the Donna North. Of course, the man who's gotten the most yards is number 28, Dominic Ochoa. And it's interesting to see what Donna North elects to do here. It's a, you know, 3rd and 5, a big 3rd and 5 with 6.5 minutes remaining in the ballgame. The Bears clinging to a 28-27 lead.
And here's Sines takes a snap. He's rolling out to his right. Only needs a few yards. We've got a flag. Looks to be a holding call when it's normally thrown in the backfield. There you see the referee trying to get a number.
I think it was number 72, big old number 72.
He's already trying to make his
case.
Got
caught red-handed right there. And now it's an interesting call. He's short of the first down. You want to have him 4th and 2?
Push him from. Late hit on the bottom. Ball is out of the restriction. That is a 15-yard penalty, number 22. For Donna North.
That's a big penalty. That's a huge, huge penalty. So both teams sort of shooting themselves in the foot right now. And luckily for the Bears, they have a 1-point lead due to a blocked extra point that almost resulted in a 2-point conversion.
So could have been fourth and two.
Two,
now
right.
Now becomes third and 26.
And a guarantee they're going to go for it on fourth and two.
Absolutely.
And now it'd be long. This is a third or fourth time Donna's having to pick up 26, 27 yards for the first down. They were successful one time. Okay, they miss. All right.
See, and you know me, Javi, I like to play that what-if game.
Yes,
so if
yes,
the Chiefs still had their two timeouts,
it
might not be two-down territory for them right now.
No.
But now they only have one timeout.
Right.
Third and 26. They have the ball at their own 23-yard line.
Yeah, they got to pick up half the yards, make it a manageable fourth down. The defense has got to come up strong right now, put pressure on the quarterback.
He's still running around trying to break free. Finally throws this one out, and it's going to fall incomplete. That one intended for number 82, Corey Harrison. And that's going to make it fourth and 21.
Yeah. Great effort right there by the Bears, chasing the quarterback around. Put a lot of pressure on him. He only really had one receiver out there. Well covered. Great job by the secondary as well.
So we've got Almaguer and Calvillo back getting ready to return the punt.
Yeah, the Bears just got to be very careful right here. Make sure they hold on to the ball. And Marroquin frantically runs down the sideline, calls a timeout. I'm not sure if he liked what he saw.
Timeout, Bears.
But I guarantee you, he's going to say, you know what, good gentlemen, play it safe, get your yardage, sit down, get out of bounds, don't fight for the extra yards, don't try to be a hero, we got the lead.
I don't know if you saw, Marroquin sprinted a good 15
yards.
I wish somebody was timing him. I would have liked to see what his time is.
He can motor down the field when he has to.
So he gets the timeout, probably didn't like what he saw. He's there talking to his special teams.
And I think that's part of it. You know, one of those things, it's fourth and a mile. It's fourth and 21. I think, you know, what he's trying to get across to the team is do not make a mistake that's going to jeopardize us retaining, you know, taking over possession of the football. Don't make a
pass interference.
Don't rough the punter. Don't face mask. Don't hold. Don't do something crazy that jeopardizes taking over the football and running out the clock, because there's only 5:56 remaining in the ball game.
Here's the punt. It's short. It's going to take a good PSJA bounce.
Oh, yeah. And they threw a penalty. Somebody threw a penalty. I'm not sure why. He threw it about 15, 20 yards. I'm not sure what the penalty was on. And the Bears should have the ball with excellent field position once again at the 34. If it is a holding penalty, it occurred at the Bears 46, 47 yard line. Tack off 10 yards from there. That might push them back all the way to their own 30, but we got a lot to work on right here. And
the referees are still
together. I think the big thing is they're trying to decide where did the penalty occur. And is it a 10-yard variety or a 15-yard variety? And if it's a 15, that's going to hurt. That's going to hurt a
holding
lot.
Holding number 7 for the Bears. That's a 10-yard penalty.
And, of course, that's a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. So that's like in reality, a 30-yard penalty, maybe a 40-yard penalty. You know, that's one thing Coach Marroquin, I'm sure, was preaching. Play smart. Be smart. And, you know, of course, when you're dealing with 15, 16, 17-year-olds, anything can happen. Emotions run high. Lesson learned. We move on. Bears clinging to a one-point lead with 5:43 remaining. This game is getting very interesting. It's the first game of the season, but it kind of feels like it's a must-win, in my sense, for the Bears. You know, you got to come out strong at home, beat a team that you should beat. And it's been a struggle. It's been a very good football game from both sides. So now Marroquin is getting his 2 cents worth, saying, but that's where I saw it. I saw it at about the 47, 48.
Right.
And, you know, you tack off 10 yards. It makes sense to me.
For those of you just joining us or haven't been able to keep up with this game,
this has been
one heck of a football game. Now, the score is 28-27. Now, judging by the score, you wouldn't be able to tell that the Bears pretty much have controlled the tempo of this football game.
Time of possession, it's been a very, very solid football game by the Bears. So, much improved Bear football team. But the key is you need to learn how to win. You know, the last year they only won one game, and that's a key. And right now they're learning the hard way, but they're hanging in there. They're learning.
Four receiver set. Well, Harlow takes a snap, fakes the handoff, but he stumbles.
Wow.
That's two possessions in a row. Am I correct?
I believe so. Their last one is what resulted in that fumble.
Somebody better call paramedic because Marroquin is going to blow a gasket, man. Wow.
Second and 14 after the four-yard loss. Clock still ticking down, so I'm assuming the PSJA Bears are going to try to milk this clock as much as they possibly can on this drive. Chiefs only have one timeout. And, of course, they're going to try to save that for as long as they can.
Yeah, they've used two timeouts possibly that they should have, but...
Here's Wahalo rolling out to his left, stays on his feet, breaking a few tackles, gets inside the 40-yard line.
Right. Plenty of time for both teams, and key here is stay in bounds.
That was number 10, Ruben Garza, and number 43, Raul Rodriguez.
We got some intense moments coming up right here. Third down for the Bears with a 28-27 lead, 4:38 remaining in the ballgame. They need to pick up 6 yards. They need to get to the 46-yard line.
Third and six. Guajardo takes the snap. Here's the handoff to the running back. This is Almaguer getting the carry. He's breaking some tackles, but can't break enough.
Wow.
Now, he stayed up, but
he did stay up, but that time stop his
forward progress. And it appeared he was going to get it. He was going north and south, or south to north, if you will. And then he decided to cut it a little bit west. And that kept them, you know, that stutter steps going side to the sideline kept them from picking it up. But here we go, fourth down
now,
and a long two.
It's fourth and two. They have it right at the 44-yard line.
Yeah, this is where you possibly try to draw them off sides and then call a timeout or even take the penalty or get a little pooch punt.
And they're going to go for it. Here's fourth and two. Guajardo tries to bounce around but nowhere to go, and he's still running around. Nothing going on. Bears probably should have taken their timeout there.
Yeah, they should have taken a timeout, try to draw them offside, take a timeout. At the very least, get a little pooch punt. You know, they're living dangerously right now. It's,
wow.
We may call the Bears a cardiac hits this year. Because.
That play just really puts a lot of pressure on your defense right now.
Yes, that, you know.
And the defense has played pretty well also.
Yeah, and maybe that's Marroquin's thinking. Our defense is stepping it up. But still, I'd rather force a team to go 80 yards instead of 43 yards, 42 yards, which Donna North is facing right now.
Here's Gutierrez getting the carries. He gets down to about close to the 40. Mark him at the 41. It looks like we almost had a little fight breaking out over here. You got
right.
Coaches.
Yeah, emotions are high. I mean... I'm telling you what, even though this is the first game of the year, this is kind of like a playoff atmosphere. Like, you know, both teams are desperate to pick up a win tonight, and it's showing, you know. Even the cheerleaders aren't cheering. They're just watching the ball game. They're like, what's going on?
You know, both of these teams have shown improvement from their last season.
Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely. These are two strong football teams.
Sainz takes a snap. He's rolling out to his right. Finds his intended receiver. That's caught by number 23, Oscar Lucio, and he has...
That's about an 8-yard pickup, depending on the spot. They're going to mark him at the 34. He's got to get to about the 32, so it'll be third and two for the Chiefs. And, you know, we're down about 2.5 minutes. The Bears have two timeouts. The Chiefs have one. They're up. The Bears are up over the Chiefs, 28-27 in a very, very exciting opening night of high school football.
Third and two, ball on the 34-yard line. Here come the Chiefs. Sainz takes the snap, hands this one off. It's a reverse. Here's number 26 getting the carry, and he's brought down in the backfield. We do have a flag that's thrown.
Yes, there is.
Now, I'm assuming that's going to be called against the Chiefs.
Yes, it should be hold. Yeah, it's definitely a hold. And I'd push him back. You know what? I'd force
holding.
Him.
Number 11 for the offense. That's a 10-yard penalty. Third down.
Yeah, that's a wise move. Instead of a
I agree with you. I wouldn't decline it.
Fourth and short.
I would take it. Push him back.
Push him back. Give him about a third and 12. You know, and it's interesting. Of course, we're undefeated. But I'm undefeated. I haven't lost a game in about 6-7 years up here in the booth, right? Well, actually, in 3 years. I'm exaggerating, of course. But where's Ochoa in all this? You know, of course, we're rooting for the Bears. We want the Bears to hold on tight. But, you know, it makes you wonder sometimes. And maybe coaches outthink themselves.
I was wondering on that last drive. Ochoa was nowhere to be seen.
Yeah, I mean.
They were going for it on fourth down, and he wasn't out there.
He's your bread and butter guy. Nowhere to be seen.
Third down, and Science breaks free from the sack, avoiding the pressure. Still on his feet, breaking tackles, has enough for the first down.
Great block,
and that's going to put him into the end zone for a touchdown.
A devastating block, just laid out the last defender that he had to beat. Very unfortunate for the Bears. And that's huge. That is a 48-yard run for a touchdown by Science. I want to say there might be a flag. I don't see it.
I think they're going to consider that one of those.
No, you know what? It's if it works out beautiful, because that denies a touchdown for the Bears. But in reality, that's just a block. It's just a block. The guy's going to go try to make a tackle. Somebody just hit him. Now, if he hits him up high, hit ahead which I think he actually did, now that I think about it. In the NFL, that might be a $10,000, $12,000 fine in a week. But here in high school football, it's just high fives from the Donna North team. And the Bears got to regroup. They still have a very good chance.
Now a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct on the bench for the Donna Chiefs.
Okay, so, yeah.
Well, it says the 15-yard assessment and off the kickoff.
That is huge. That's huge.
But it is a touchdown.
It is a touchdown. But I tell you, they're going to have to kick off from the 25 into the win, and the flag's just kicked up right now. So a minute and a half, minute 40, they put 5 more seconds up on their. Now the thing is, does Donna North go for two? If they do and they do not make it, the Bears can go for two and win the game.
After the 48-yard run, here we go, going for two. And this one through the hands of the intended receiver. But there is a flag thrown. So we'll see what the penalty.
No double receiver downfield. The try is no good. Well, it says the 15-yard penalty off the kickoff.
Well, the good news for the Bears is they should get the ball close to midfield.
Right.
They're going to have two timeouts and just a tad over a minute and a half to work some magic. I tell you what, Trey Wajardo is a man who he can guide them. The other thing we haven't seen much from the Bears here in the second half is no attempts to Dunaway. They got a big mismatch on size advantage as far as receiver.
We mentioned that earlier. They have Oscar Salas trying to cover Anthony Dunaway. You're talking about a
5'6", 5'7" cornerback against a 6'3", very athletic receiver. The mismatch is there. It's just a matter of exploiting it.
Now, in the last few drives, I guess we can understand because the Bears were pretty much trying to run out the
clock.
They're
running it, yeah. Mm-hmm. What hurts the Bears again is you don't have that bruiser to end the clock, to run the clock out. In Castillo.
Mark Castillo. They're missing him right now.
Yes. Against your scat back, But you need that bruiser to get those tough 2-3 yards right up the middle. And that's been a big minus that the Bears have had tonight in missing Castillo.
And, Castillo's that running back who can carry the ball 4 straight times.
Yes, yes.
He'll pick up 3 yards, 2 yards.
Yeah, exactly. He's one of those guys. The more you give it to him, the harder he's going to run. He's going to punish that defense.
So here's the kick. Fielded by Almaguer at his own 30. Now he's at the 40, close to midfield. He's at the 40, still on his feet, finally brought down.
Great kickoff return.
At the 30.
My goodness, if he doesn't get tripped up, the Bears are celebrating in the end zone. But I tell you what, great kickoff return. Almaguer almost takes it all the way to the house. They're going to set up in excellent field position. As we mentioned, I thought they'd be near midfield. Heck, they're inside the 30-yard line.
And I'll tell you what, if the Chiefs, well, here we'll see it on the replay. Here's the kick. Almaguez is going to field it right around his own 30.
Yeah.
Just a great wall of blockers right there. You see nothing. Look, I don't even see a white jersey yet.
No.
And here you go. And I'll tell you what, number 44.
The kicker just kind of stood there. If he does, that's.
I'll tell you what, if the Chiefs can hold them, the defense can hold the Bears on this drive, your kicker's going to be the hero of the game because that would have been a touchdown. So here we go, first and 10. Guajardo takes the snap. Quarterback keeper up the middle. He's inside the 30-yard line, down at the 29. Second and 7 after he picks up 3 yards. Clock ticking down to about a minute and 15 seconds. Bears with 2 timeouts.
Yeah, they got plenty of time. They got plenty of time. And right now we got Dunaway here on the left hash mark on the numbers. He's 6'2", 6'3". He's being guarded by number 2 from Donna. Julian Perez, Oscar Salas, minuscule player, but yet they elect to run the ball once again.
Here's Almaguer getting it down to about the 27.
I take my chances with Dunaway, at least once. It's third down.
It's third down. You're
less than a minute to go. Wow, I didn't expect this kind of ball game. I am.
Timeout. Bears.
It's coming down to the wire, and it's kind of like you mentioned, and I hope what you said earlier comes true to fruition, saying whoever has the ball last is going to win this ball game. And right
that's
now the Bears
pretty much what it is. Bears have it last.
Bears have 1 timeout left.
They have a great opportunity. Each team with 1 timeout left, of course, the Bears with the ball. The Bears would need a touchdown to win the ball game, which surprised me when Donna North didn't kick that extra point. You know, make him at least get a touchdown and tie it. Yeah. They failed on the 2 points. So a touchdown by the Bears, like, sneaks out a 34-33 win. And, you know, the Bears are 28 yards away from that.
And you know how we've said it over and over, it's kind of easy for us, you know,
yes,
up here to
yes,
make calls.
Yeah, we don't make mistakes up here. You know, you're down there, you're living in live, you know, with the emotions, with the players, with the, you know, everything. It's a whole different animal.
I just really think that second down was a perfect opportunity to try to go for something maybe towards Dunaway.
Right.
You could have stopped the clock with an incomplete, still had that timeout.
Yeah. And you know, I isolate Dunaway on one side of the field. Just, hey, me and one guy, I can beat him. Just give me the ball.
Here's a snap to Guajardo. Here's going to be a reverse to Calvillo. Lots of running room. He takes it up the middle. He's inside the 20. Still on his feet. He's at the 10. He's still in bounds, out of bounds at the 5.
Wow.
Finally forced out by number 14, Alex Gonzalez. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got 34 seconds left.
This is when, you know, you want a big, you know, bring in that William Refrigerator Perry kind of guy. Just give it to him 2-3 times, pound it in. He's still got some work to do. I thought he got inside the 5-yard line.
I thought he did
line.
Too, but they're gonna mark it out at the 7.
It's been, you know, we never want to criticize any official, but it's been a little iffy tonight. Of course, it's an opening night for everyone tonight. The Bears with a golden opportunity to get the win.
Fumble snap, Guajardo picks it up, and he's breaking free, and he's gonna be forced out of bounds. Maybe should have thrown it away. I'm not sure what the if it was a run play or maybe it was a pass.
Right, you're spot on that. The only thing with that though, if it was a true run play,
you got linemen down.
You got and it's gonna be legal man downfield. Now we got a penalty, but yes, he did. He still managed to move it upfield. He lost a couple yards. They're at the 9. They got 26.8 seconds. We got 1 timeout on each side. I'm surprised Donna North hasn't called a timeout to regroup. Execution is going to be key right here.
Second and 9, 4 receivers set for the Bears. Play clock down to 1. Guajardo takes the snap, hands it off to Almaguer. Almaguer is in the end zone for a touchdown.
Wow.
What a game, ladies and gentlemen.
Clutch play. That's a play you want Castillo with. You know, a bruiser right up the middle. Instead, they get great offensive blocking. The guard tackle just opened up a seam. A big opening for Almaguer to run through. He burst through the seam, got hit right at about the goal line. He sneaks it in. He gets in. 34-33, the Bears, the cardiac hits. Right now, holding on to 1 point lead. Of course, we still got 21.8 seconds, and anything is possible
anything
in football.
Happen. I'm still trying to catch my breath.
Bears.
Now,
that's your last timeout of the second half.
Well, I tell you why they called a timeout. I think they got excited. They sent the kick, the field goal unit out there. They're up by one.
They need two points
to force Donna North. If
now
they do
it,
to a
field goal,
they just tie it.
Right.
Right. A touchdown either way, you know, Donna North, miracle touchdown, Donna North wins. But yes, they got a, I'm glad they picked that up. They were close to kicking it. Wow, what an excitement. I tell you what, Coach Garcia and, you know, Coach Mel Rios, with our athletic coordinator, they may raise the prices because, you know, you people got a bargain here tonight. Wow. They got their money's worth and some more tonight. Beautiful ball game.
Everyone in this stadium is on their feet.
Yes, and unfortunately, you know, there's got to be a winner. There's got to be a loser. But my hat's off to both teams. Very well played football game. And, of course, the Bears right now riding a one-point lead.
So here we go, going for two. After the 7-yard touchdown run by Almaguer puts them up by one, 34-33. Here's the 2-point conversion. Guajardo has this one. He's going up the middle. Did he make it?
He
got it.
Yes, he did.
The 2-point conversion
is good. That is huge right there.
Absolutely, because as you said earlier, Javi, now a field goal can only tie it. But there's still 21.8 seconds.
Yes.
Still one timeout.
You know, this is one where, thinking outside the box. Kick it out of bounds. You know, kick it out of bounds. Make sure you pass midfield them. Make them pick it up at
make
the 30.
Work.
Make them start at the 30. They, you know, the Chiefs have one timeout. Make them drive it 70 yards into a light breeze. You know, crazy game. You know, what a way to start the season on a Friday night. You know, last night we had the Javelinas dominate. You know, that was a game clearly in hand by the Javelinas. Javelinas, great effort last night. But tonight, the Bears in a big time struggle. But I tell you what, as you mentioned earlier, the Bears only had one win last season. You got to grow up to win a football game. It's not easy to win a high school football game, and tonight the Bears are demonstrating that their hard work, dedication, and the maturity is starting to pay off. And hopefully this big win leads to a big season. I hope this catapults them into a realm where they're going to challenge for a playoff spot, and maybe, who knows, maybe even a district title this year.
So here we go with 21.8 seconds left to go here in this amazing
It's been fun.
Game. It's been fun.
it's been one of the
fantastic.
Better games we've seen.
So here we go. Figueroa getting ready to kick this one off. Here's the kick by Figueroa. Fielded at the 10. Fumbled, muffed. Picked up by the return man. And he's met at the 20 spin move.
Uh-oh, he's got a little seam, one man to beat.
But now he's running backwards.
And he's getting a lot of the clock.
And he's wasting a lot of time. Now he got it with 20-some seconds left. Didn't matter anything, we're able to run a play. So here comes Figueroa. He's still running out.
Well, I think he...
That's it, he killed the clock.
He ran the whole clock. Oh, my goodness.
That was the longest return that went nowhere.
You know what? The reason I'm cracking up, I mean, great effort by the Bears. But usually you do that if you're trying to run out the clock.
Yeah. But nonetheless, it was still a great game by both teams.
I take my hats off to every single individual that played this football game tonight, all the coaches. Outstanding effort. The Bears win. Bears pick up a huge win. 34-36-33.
Just a great game. Ladies and gentlemen, we will be back next week. Our final score here at PSJA Stadium is the PSJA Bears 36, the Donna North Chiefs 33.